Hi, this is Misty Zek.
This is Brock Nohava.
Hi, this is Abby Phillips.
I'm Carissa DeRocher.
This is Dave Close.
Hi, this is Austin Sitzman.
Hi, this is Jody with Exit Realty Midwest.
Exit Realty Midwest is proud to support our area athletes. Find them online at exitrealtymidwest.com.
A home is a safe place to be, a roof over your head and four walls to keep out the heat and cold. It's a child's laughter, a mother's song, and a father's strength. It's where we go for comfort and to share joy. It's your first school and your first church. It's where memories are shared. Hi, this is Julie Hurt, your Century 21 ProLink real estate agent. Whatever a home means to you, I am here to help you find the home you are looking for. Call 540-7757 and let me, Julie Hurt, help you make a house your new home.
Campbell's Rental and Repair, located on the corner of 4th Avenue Northeast and 1st Street, is a proud supporter of local athletics. For all your Toro product purchase, rental, or repair, visit Campbell's Rental and Repair today. They have a full line of Toro products for you to purchase or rent.
Zoolan Glass is so glad you're supporting local athletes and listening to this great matchup. Zoolan Glass wants me to tell you that if you have a chip or crack in your windshield or need the whole thing replaced, you can call them at 540-9080. Zoolan Glass!
Peace Pizza House is your destination before and after the game. Whether you need to feed the whole family or just looking to get out before the game, make sure to stop at Peace Pizza House. You'll find many appetizers, burgers, salads, pasta, and of course, Peace Pizza House outstanding pizza selections. Your entire family is sure to find something they're looking for. Peace Pizza House would like to wish our local teams the best of luck this season.
Get more because you deserve more with Kylie Petty, Century 21 ProLink, serving Lamar since 2011. Wishing our local teams a successful season. Visit KyliePetty.com for your real estate needs.
It's now time for high school football on 1410 AM, 96.9 FM, KLEM.
He takes the snap, handoff left side, goes to Pearson. He's got a big hole, lowers his shoulder, and he dives into the end zone for a Gehlen Catholic touchdown.
High school football.
Foreman gets the snap off, and it's blocked by Gabe Wilchin. The punt is blocked by Wilchin. It's recovered at the 25-yard line by Cale Pearson.
With all the action, here's KLEM Sports Director Daniel Versteeg.
And a very pleasant good Friday evening to you high school football fans. It's week two of the football season, and district play gets underway tonight in Class A football, and we've got a good local matchup for you. The Gehlen Catholic Jays head east to Marcus for a matchup with the Royals of MMCRU. A couple of 0-1 teams who did not get out of the gates on a high note in any of their contests, but looking to turn things around and start off district play 1-0. They've got an opportunity to do that here tonight. Once again, good evening, everyone. Daniel Versteeg with you. Welcome into our Friday night football pregame show. Gehlen Catholic and MMCRU football. It's right here on 1410 AM and 96.9 FM. It's KLEM Lamar's. You can also listen to this game online at KLEM1410.com, or you can watch this game live on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel. And we thank our great sponsors like Pease Pizza House, Easy Clean Car Wash, Northwest Bank, and Julie Hurt, realtor at Century 21 ProLink. And of course, the great hospitality of the folks here at MMCRU Community School District. Of course, we were not able to bring you a stream down in Sergeant Bluff last week, but thanks to great school districts like MMCRU, we're able to bring you the contest here tonight on our video stream as well. It's going to be a great ball game, MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic. Now, if you're thinking about this from a historical standpoint, you'd think, well, these ball games have never been good. Galen's always been able to beat MMCRU convincingly. It's never been a close game. I would take that line of thinking and throw it out the window, because this MMCRU team is much improved. Yes, they lost 51-23 last week to Cherokee. That doesn't tell the story. This Royal football team brought back a ton of talent, and I know last week didn't go the way they wanted, but Coach Oswald has reminded the guys that they have a job to do. They got to do it to be successful, and that was the motto here in this last week of practice. We're going to hear from Coach Oswald coming up in our pregame show, and MMCRU is motivated, of course. They want to have a ton of success. Coach Oswald told us preseason that there's no excuse anymore. There's no excuse for the Royals to not be a good football team in this area, and they're hoping that they can get things started with their first win here this week. Meanwhile, Gehlen Catholic's coming off a 10-0 loss. The offense had many chances, multiple chances to score. You heard that in our little snippet there with Kadrian Harderson on the Radio Iowa Scouting Report. The Blackhawk defense stood tall. The Gehlen Catholic offense did not come through a couple of times down inside the red zone last week at Jim Lorenzen Field, and I know Coach Schindler was not pleased with that effort and hoping for a turnaround offensively here tonight. Should be a great contest in Class A District 1. District play opening up around the area. Akron Westfield's taking on Sibley O'Cheadon in this district as well. South O'Brien's got Sheldon. HMS has got Alta Aurelia. And, many more games around the area that we're going to try and keep you up to date on as we bring you this contest as well. MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic, it's our Friday Night Football pregame show. Let's take a break and let's get the guys on that can tell you more about this game. That's both head coaches. Jeremy Schindler, head coach of Gehlen Catholic Football, joins us in just a couple of minutes. MMCRU head coach Kyle Oswald joins us after that on our Friday Night Football pregame show, live from Marcus as Gehlen Catholic gets ready to take on MMCRU. Right here on KLEM Radio.
For all of your commercial or residential concrete or construction needs, J-Max Construction is ready for you. At J-Max Construction, you can be sure that your project will be handled with great customer service as well as the best of class construction and concrete work. Call J-Max Construction and Concrete today at 540-0574.
Get a special loan rate from Northwest Bank. Remodel your home, take a vacation, or buy a car. Use the equity in your home for what you want. Northwest Bank's home equity line of credit special of 6.99% annual percentage rate, fixed for 6 months, then variable rate thereafter, currently 7.50% APR. Offer available for a limited time to qualified borrowers. Call 800-678-4105 for details about credit cost and terms. Apply online at nw.bank.
Commitment you can bank on.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
At Universal Windows Direct, you're not just purchasing windows. You're also getting peace of mind, knowing that their knowledgeable local staff is there for you every step of the way. You receive quality Unishield products along with a limited lifetime warranty to ensure that you're taken care of for years to come. Universal Windows Direct wishes all local athletes the best of luck.
This is Jeremy Schindler, head coach for the Gehlen Catholic football team. You're listening to Jays Football on 1410 AM, 96.9 FM, KLEM.
We welcome you back to our Friday Night Football pregame show right here on KLEM Radio. It's week two of the high school football season. District play starting in Class A. Daniel Versteg with you. Pleased to be joined by the head coach of Gehlen Catholic football, Coach Jeremy Schindler. The Jays are coming off a loss to open the season. Got shut out in a 10-0 contest with Hinton at Jim Lorenzen Field last week. And Coach, just first of all, week one, there's a lot of things that, you know, can happen and kind of mentality-wise can go into week one. What kind of things did you guys learn from last week's game that you guys were able to address and approach this week in practice?
Yeah, I think offensively the couple biggest things that we learned is we can't hurt ourselves with penalties and turnovers. If we stay on schedule, you know, we're tougher to beat. And, you know, just maintaining our blocks, whether that's in the line of scrimmage or out on the perimeter, we need to maintain our blocks for, you know, a couple extra seconds to allow for those big plays. And so that's really the things we've been working on the most this week is discipline, you know, for penalties, and discipline, not turning the ball over, and then, you know, just finishing plays, whether that's, finishing it where you're taking a kid and blocking him 15 yards downfield or back and you're, you know, finishing going forward and you got the ball, or you're carrying out a fake if you're a quarterback or something like that, you know, because all of that, when all of that starts to work together, that's when we're going to see this offense take off. In terms of defense, you know, this is a different challenge this week. We just have to make sure we communicate and understand what coverages we're in, because MMCRU will definitely challenge us more through the air than Hinton did.
Yeah, absolutely. I was looking at that, and they threw the ball a lot more than they ran the ball. But the positives for use guys, at least, is while the offense didn't really live up to maybe the standards you set for yourself last week and was shut out against Hinton, you guys defensively I looked pretty good with just the 10 points allowed, and you outgained Hinton. Is there some confidence and some momentum being taken in by the defensive unit into this contest?
Yeah, I think our front seven definitely should be playing very confidently. You know, those were the guys who were kind of challenged with Hinton's run game, and I thought they did a really good job of, you know, standing up to it. The quarterback hurt us a little bit, but their backs didn't get free too much. So, again, it's just something that we're going to continue to work on, stopping that QB run game as well. The secondary didn't get tested a lot, but, only giving up, I think, two completions all game, seven or eight passes, I think, is what Hinton had. So the secondary should be pretty confident, too. We're definitely going to get tested more. Marcus is going to throw the ball a lot more than Hinton did, but we have the confidence in those guys to, when the ball's in the air, go make a play on it.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, you mentioned this this MMCRU squad throwing the ball a ton, and we saw that even in a bit of a lopsided loss to Cherokee from them last week. Just, Coach, I guess when it comes to the secondary play and what you could see from the Royals throwing the football tonight, what are some of the things that you need the secondary to be good on and so that you're not giving up big plays and, just getting thrown all over the field?
Yeah, I mean, communicating is the biggest thing. Making sure everybody's in the same coverage and making sure we pass that down. And, if you got one kid playing one coverage and another kid playing a different coverage, usually that's a book, and there's going to be a zone wide open. So we need to understand what coverage Coach Ellen's zone puts us in and then execute. And whether you're supposed to stop a receiver or if you're supposed to be more aggressive and try and jump the route, whatever your job is, just making sure you're doing your job in the secondary and not trying to do someone else's job.
Jeremy Schindler's with us, head coach of Gehlen Catholic football. Jays taking on MMCRU this week in Marcus in week two of the high school football season. I look at the passing game, and, yeah, obviously that's a big deal for them. How do you balance the respect for that with also the respect for that back in the backfield that ran for over 100 yards in Brayson Mulder last week?
Yeah, he's a nice running back, you know, only being a sophomore, good-sized kid. I think he's about 6 foot, 6'1", maybe a little over 200 pounds. So he's a nice-sized kid, got some good speed, good vision, finishes runs well. I think the biggest thing is trying to get a good run-pass read off of their linemen. They're not a huge drive-blocking team. They kind of want to try and shield and then try and open up holes that way, shield your defender out. So our defensive line has to do a really good job of when you feel pressure one way, you got to fight that pressure and squeeze that hole down and then go make a play on the ball. And so it starts up front with those guys. Linebackers got to understand, you know, get a good read off of what the linemen are doing. And then, you know, if it's run, you got to fill your gap and make a tackle in the hole. And if it's pass, you got to get back. You got to get back into your drop and try and get to about 10, 12, 15 yards deep so we can hopefully get our hands on the ball.
How about the defensive side, Coach? You, if you look at last week's game, you're probably thinking, well, their defense isn't much to speak of, but obviously there's only one game to look at there. So what kind of things did stand out about their defense that you're able to prepare for this week?
You know, they switch defenses. They've always been, since I've been coaching against them, they've been a 3-5 defense, and they've moved to a more of a traditional forefront. They stand their defensive ends up. Again, their two defensive ends are more linebacker type kids, so they're a little more athletic. But they do put a couple big bodies right in the middle there, so they're playing a forefront. And it just kind of depends what formation you're in, whether you're going to get a 4-3 or a 4-4 look out of them. So we got to make sure that we take advantage of the number situation and hopefully find a way to get a numbers advantage in our run and pass game.
You know, and the aspect you talk about there with their standing up their defensive ends. I mean, it sounds like they want to use some athleticism there when it comes to edge rushing and pressure that they could put on you guys. What kind of things do you guys need to do on the offensive line to recognize that, to keep those guys, those athletic and agile guys on the outside from, having a field day, whether it's on, Cole and dropping back to pass, or it's on Kale who can't get a run started?
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is communicating with one another and making sure, we get the right calls in on the offensive line as to who's working with who and the double teams. And then just Kale's got to do a good job of pressing it in there. And when you see the hole, you got to hit it. And our line has to do a good job of, getting some movement with that front line and then hopefully getting off and getting a piece of the linebackers. You know, that's where the big plays happen, when you can get a big double team and then you slide off and are able to seal off one of the linebackers. You know, Kale will squirt through there real quick, or Cole or even Jake Bogan, that's really the key, is communication and then just getting off the ball and moving that front line.
You've talked about communicating a couple of times now. You also mentioned earlier on about limiting penalties, turnovers, some of those silly mistakes that happen in week one. What other things have to happen differently for the Jays here tonight so that they can start off district play with a 1-0 record in a big game here in week two?
Yeah, I think we need to be a little more diverse in the passing game, and there's some little wrinkles that we've put in. We're not gonna drop back and throw it, 20, 30 times like we did last year. That's just not what this team is. But, we can still be effective in the passing game. And other than the interception last week, Cole, I thought actually, threw the ball pretty well. He was 3 of 3 before that last drive when we tried to throw it deep twice, and one was an incompletion and one was an interception. So it was actually working just the way we wanted it to. Probably need to have a little more confidence in that as a play caller. But I think it's looked pretty good this week in practice, so that's something that we're not going to be afraid to go to. And then we got to continue to tackle well. I thought we tackled pretty good for a first game. I was pretty impressed with it. Mm-hmm. And then Coach Ellenzone is always preaching, we got to take the ball away from the other team. We got to force some turnovers. That's the way this defense is designed. It's going to be a little bit of a bend, but don't break. And we did a great job of that last week. We bent in the first half, and they were inside the 10, and we ended up holding them to a field goal, which is exactly what we wanted. That's a win for us. The only time they scored was off of a turnover for us, which gave them an extremely short field. So if you look at one area defensively that we need to get better at, is creating those turnovers. And I think, with the way Marcus plays, you're going to have an opportunity to make some plays in the secondary. Mm-hmm. So when the ball goes up, we got to get our hands on it.
Well, absolutely. Hope that happens. Hoping for a much better turnover margin and a better outcome here tonight. Coach, we appreciate your time. Best of luck tonight, and we'll talk to you on Saturday.
Sounds good. Thanks, Daniel.
Absolutely. It's Jeremy Schindler, head coach of Gehlen Catholic football, on our pregame coverage. More from Marcus after this on KLEM.
Hi, Jessica G.
Well, hello, Libby Lexus.
I'm so excited to get the spa treatment at Easy Clean Car Wash. My owner knows how much I love the soft water. Oh, and the quick massage just makes my bumpers tingle.
And the blow dry is to die for. It always leaves my exterior sleek and shiny.
My owner bought me a year pass so I can have the spa treatment anytime I want.
Hey, ladies. Ooh, nice tires.
Oh, Mickey Mustang, you're such a player.
Easy Clean Car Wash. Give your car the spa treatment today. 12th Street east of Hy-Vee. Lamar's.
You're listening to High School Football on 1410 AM, 96.9 FM, KLEM.
Welcome back to our Friday Night Football pregame show here on KLEM Radio. Daniel Versteg with you. It's week two of the high school football season, district play in Class A, and that means a couple of area teams are going at it. We're chatting with MMCRU head football coach Kyle Oswald. The Royals coming off a loss to Cherokee last week to open up the season 0-1. And coach, it was just kind of a tough game for you guys last week up in Cherokee. What were some of the things that you guys learned about your team that you were able to address this week in practice?
Just the discipline aspect, self-discipline, things that had gone so smoothly. We just thought we were flying high on a lot of areas that when it came game time, we ignored, that we just reverted back to certain things instead of being diligent to do our job. And so that's our phrase of the week, is do your job. Just because we got to quit trying to be the hero and change the momentum by ourselves. We as a team can change the momentum, but only if we're doing our jobs as individuals. And that's why there's 11 guys out there, not one. And so that's something we really preach this week, is just do your job, be confident in what you have, and then go out and perform.
And, you know, the nice thing is while the result on the scoreboard was not – you know, what you guys wanted, obviously. You guys got down early, and I think a lot of guys on that sideline could have said, all right, well, let's just pack the bus, go through the motion last half. But you guys never really gave in. I mean, it had to be nice for you as a coach to see that the guys were able to finish the game, finish the job on Friday night, even though the scoreboard didn't, you know, go your way.
Yeah, I will say that. We didn't have any quit. But there's plenty of frustration, plenty of how is this possible, and coaches too as well, thinking of that. And then you watch film and you go, oh, that's how it's possible. Well, at least, I mean, the nice thing is it did go our way. A lot of us felt embarrassed on how the ending went. But after watching film, we're like, okay, we're not completely broken. We don't have to start over from scratch. We've got opportunities here. All it needs is a little tweaking. We don't need an overhaul. We just need a tune-up. And so that's the nice thing that we've got moving forward.
And the nice thing is there's always a game afterwards to improve things, and that's coming up tonight with the Gehlen Catholic Jays, start of district play. Coach, I guess just first of all, let's look at their offensive side of the ball, a team that did not score a point last week, so there really wasn't a whole lot for them to be excited on offensively last week. Just what kind of things have you seen that you guys have to be prepared for from them?
Well, they might not have gotten the end zone, but they got the ball moved up and down the field.
Right.
They got some decent stats. Their running backs was pretty quick dude. We saw him last year, and we're surprised on that. And the fact of the matter is, you know, we have never beat Gehlen and barely even come within a sniff of it. So we can't go in looking at, hey, they didn't score any points. That means nothing to me this week.
Sure.
I mean, it should mean nothing to our guys. That what means things is everybody has opportunity right now in our district to do something. Mm-hmm. Nobody in our district won last week, and that's going to change one way or another this week. So what we know is they know what it takes to do well in our district. They've been there before. Their coach has done a good job with the guys he's had. And you know, again, we've never beaten Gehlen. So the last thing they want is to lose that over us. They don't want this to be the first time. So we've got to ensure that we're ready for that. They're not just going to come and let us take that first time. So we know that they've got some meat up front. You only get one film, so you never know if there's more stuff at the second game of the year that gets worked on or not.
Right. Well, and you highlighted that that running back. Yeah, he had over 100 yards. You mentioned they've got some good linemen up there protecting for him. Just what are some of the things you need to see out of your front seven, or I guess the entirety of the defense, to be able to shut down that running game and take that away from them? Because like you said, that was their ability to move the football last week.
It just comes back to last week as far as do your job. And then we got to tackle. Like, we didn't tackle worth a hoot last year, or last week, I'm sorry. And we do those two things, and we're going to be able to relax a little bit more. But if we don't make tackles, and if we don't do our job, then we're going to be scrambling. And I would rather be able to be on offense and do what we want to do because we can, versus having to do a bunch of things because we have to dig out of a hole.
Kyle Oswald with us, head coach of MMCRU football, talking about the matchup with Gehlen Catholic coming up tonight here on KLEM Radio. So when you guys are on offense, obviously you guys Moved the football pretty well, all things considered, last week, whether that was through the air, and you had over 100 yards on the ground with Brayson Mulder. Just what kind of things do you see from Galen's side on the defensive end, and how do you need to attack it so that, you know, you guys can continue to move the football and, you know, take that into this week?
Well, we've been trying to make sure we get multiple looks in practice. Last year they ran a different defense on us than they did anybody else until, you know, they'd run a certain defense and we saw them, they ran something completely different. So we were just trying to be across the board, ready to go, and prepare for everything.
Yeah, and, you know, you guys being prepared, obviously you guys want to move the ball when it comes to the passing game. How does, you know, preparing for whether it's a three front, a four front, you know, things like that, how does that prepare you to, you know, have success in the passing game? Because I think a lot of people listening to the game of football or watching the game of football would think, well, the passing game, it kind of starts and ends with your secondary and your skill guys on the outside. But how does the battle in the trenches really impact the passing game?
Well, you can't throw it to somebody if your quarterback's getting sacked, so there's that.
Right.
But as I've always said, I want to be able to pass when I want to pass, not because I have to pass.
Sure.
I want to be able to run the ball so then I can throw it when I want to. And so if we can't establish a run game, then it's not going to help us a whole lot to throw the ball around.
Last thing for you, Coach. This is obviously a big game for a number of reasons. Like you said, you've never beaten Gehlen. This is the start of district play, all these kind of things. You want your first win of the year. Just what kind of things, what are some keys to this game that you kind of have to see from the guys to suggest that you're going to have a good shot at starting district play off 1-0 and getting that elusive win over the Jays?
I know I've sound like a broken record here, but just consistency and doing your job. I mean, that was when we watched film over and over. You thought you saw some of it on the game night, and then you watched the film and you went, "Wow, this is worse than we thought." Mm-hmm. And just consistency. Trust in your teammates. Trust that if you do your job, they're going to do theirs. And then, you know, make your tackles. Mm-hmm. If we can tackle and do our job on defense, that takes a breather off of our offense. And I hesitate to use the word even confident, but we're pretty happy with what we think we can do on offense and our ground game. But if we can play to our potential on defense, and I mean, really, the thing I'm happy about is to know that it's not like these are not fixable things.
Right.
We didn't have to start over. We do know what went wrong, and we've been working on how to fix it. So as long as we do that, you do your job, and good things are going to happen.
Absolutely. Hope good things are in store for the Royals here tonight. We look forward to the contest. Coach, we appreciate your time as always, and best of luck to you guys.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely. Kyle Oswald, head coach of MMCRU football on our pregame coverage. More from Marcus after this here on KLEM.
A home is a safe place to be, a roof over your head, and four walls to keep out the heat and cold. It's a child's laughter, a mother's song, and a father's strength. It's where we go for comfort and to share joy. It's your first school and your first church. It's where memories are shared. Hi, this is Julie Hurt, your Century 21 ProLink real estate agent. Whatever a home means to you, I am here to help you find the home you are looking for. Call 540-7757 and let me, Julie Hurt, help you make a house your new home.
This is Chance Kelson, and you are listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
And we welcome you back here to Marcus and Harold Wood Field for week two of the high school football season on KLEM Radio. Online audio is found on our website at KLEM1410.com. And you can tune in to a video stream as well. That's on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel. Thanks to our great video sponsors, Pease Pizza House, Northwest Bank, Easy Clean Car Wash, and Julie Hurt, realtor with Century 21 ProLink. You've heard from both coaches. We're ready to get this one underway. At least we are for the moment anyway. The play clock on the east end of the field is currently not operational, but of course that's a big deal because MMCRU won the coin toss. They've elected to receive the football. They want it first, and they're going to be attacking that east end of the field. So as of right now, I think they're just going to play without that play clock going. And so we are ready to get this one underway. Our clock's at 7 o'clock. It is a great night for football. A little warm here to start things off. Should turn into a great night when things are all said and done. Dylan Pakus has lined it up at the 40-yard line. He's ready to boot this one away for Gehlen Catholic. And for MMCRU back deep to return, it's Jace Calling and Brayson Muller. Here we go. District play in Class A. District 1 is ready to get underway with a right-footed boot from Dylan Pakus. He approaches and sends it away. It's a high end over end. This one bounced at the 10, rolls into the arms of Jace Calling, who picks it up, takes it up the right seam to the 25, steps over a defender, and gets wrestled down across the 25 to the 26-yard line. And that's where MMCRU will start their first drive of the contest with 11:53 to go in quarter number one. So we're going to see that MMCRU offense that, despite losing by 28 points, put up over 300 yards of total offense last week against Cherokee. 303 total, 114 on the ground, 189 passing. And now Jonah Peterson lines up his offense with a back in the backfield in the pistol formation. Two receivers left and one to his right. Claps his hands, throws a screen pass left side. Jace Calling takes up the left sideline, getting a block out there from Kyler Bork. He's across the 35, and he's got a first down right away up to the 40-yard line. A pickup of 40 yards, and right away, MMCRU's got a first down on the completion from Peterson to Jace Calling. Outstanding block on the outside from Kyler Bork. That's not going to go unnoticed, I don't think, by Coach Oswald or any of his assistant coaches. First and 10 now for MMCRU. This down and distance at their own 40-yard line. Pistol set for Peterson again. Two receivers right. He turns to his left, gives to Mulder. Carries off tackle left side. He drags defenders across the 45, and he's down short of the line to gain of the 48-yard line. It's a gain of 8 yards. It'll be second down and two here for MMCRU. So the Royals on their first couple of plays, moving the ball well, taking things wide to the sideline. You see MMCRU spread their receivers out very wide. They don't keep anything too tight to the formation. They want to use the entire field boundary to boundary, and that's what can make an offense very successful. Second down and two at the 48-yard line. MMCRU lined up on the left hash mark. Two receiver right. Peterson throws a screen pass right side. It's Calling again. Another block gets him across midfield and a first down into Gehlen Catholic territory at the 46-yard line. It's going to be a gain of about 6 yards and a first down here for MMCRU. Another first down, and once again, it is on a screen pass to Jace Calling. Calling last week had 6 catches for 62 yards, averaging a first down and a little bit extra per reception. So first and 10 up to the Gehlen Catholic 46-yard line roughly. 10:40 to go in the first quarter. First drive of the ballgame. Now an I formation. Peterson goes under center, turns to his right, and gives it to Brayson Mulder, who carries up the middle to the 45-yard line. They push a scrum up to the 41, and he's got the 40 as well. Not quite. Just a gain of 6 for Brayson Mulder. And that'll set up second down at about 4 to go to the Gehlen Catholic 41-yard line. Boy, if you're watching the stream, you just saw a dinosaur in the form of an under-center I formation, especially for MMCRU. Good to see. We love power football. It's fun to watch, especially here in Class A. We're seeing it again. I formation, Peterson under-center, two receivers left. And none to his right. Peterson gives a straight-ahead run up the middle. Mulder's got a first down, but there's a flag in the pile. It's probably going to be a holding penalty as Mulder gets tackled across the 30 to the 28-yard line. MMCRU is going to hold their excitement, and it is going to be a flag against the Royals. A holding penalty is going to back them off. Back across midfield, that's a harsh 10-yard penalty. And, of course, you don't go from the spot of the foul unless it's in front of the line of scrimmage now. That's the new rule for the holding penalty. So they'll march this back across the 50-yard line on a holding penalty against MMCRU, back to their own 49-yard line. So now it'll be about second and 14 maybe. So penalty, 10-yard penalty, backs them up to the 49, their own 49-yard line. Second down and about 14 to go now for MMCRU. Gehlen Catholic coach Jeremy Schindler talked about this being behind schedule. See how MMCRU does being behind schedule. Play action, bootleg, throw left side is caught. It is caught by Kyler Bork across the 35. He's wrestled down to the 31. He's got an MMCRU first down on a gain of 20 yards to the Gehlen Catholic 31-yard line. What a great play call as the pass was thrown off the bootleg to the left side in a play action look. And Kyler Bork made his first catch of the night. First catch of the year as well. First and 10 here for MMCRU now to the Gehlen Catholic 31. J defense needs to find something to stop here and with 9:15 to go in the first quarter. I formation look again. Peterson gives up the middle. Mulder trying to knife his way through that pile. He is being stood up and brought down at the 28-yard line. That's a gain of three. And it'll set up second down and seven to go here for MMCRU as they start. They just continue to work their way down the field. They've gone 50 yards so far, roughly 50 yards. Trying to get on the board first. Of course, MMCRU coming off a 51-23 loss to Cherokee last week. Gehlen Catholic did not score in a 10-0 shutout against Hinton last week to go 0-1. It is second down and seven here at the Gehlen Catholic 28. Peterson goes under center, I formation, a receiver on either side. He gives right side. This carry goes to the right side for Dawson Pick, and he gets stood up at the line of scrimmage for no gain. Looks like Will Harpinaw was there. So is Jake Bogan on the stop. It's no gain for Dawson Pick. And it'll now be third down and seven here for MMCRU. So some work to do now for MMCRU with a third down and longer than they were anticipating. Third down and about seven or eight to go. Got to basically get to the red zone. 21-yard line, roughly speaking, is the line to gain. It is third down and seven. Trip receiver set to the right in the pistol formation. Peterson with a belt high snap and a short drop. He pump fakes, lobs it up on the middle. Wide open receiver. It's hauled in for an MMCRU touchdown. Gage Johnson with a second touchdown reception of the year. This one comes from 28 yards out. And MMCRU strikes first. It's 6-0 Royals here with 7:46 to go in quarter number one. What a great touchdown pass, 28 yards to Gage Johnson, his second touchdown reception of the year. And now a point after upcoming here for MMCRU. They are going to go with Cody Evans to try and boot this one through. He went perfect, 3-for-3 on his point after tries last week against Cherokee. So the point after try upcoming for Cody Evans. He marks it off, lines it up. The snap and the spot is good. The right-footed kick, it is through the uprights and good. Point after try is good, and the score now after the first drive of the night. It's MMCRU 7, Gehlen Catholic nothing. 7:46 to play here in the first quarter. We'll take a timeout. We're back with more district football in Class A District 1 after this break here on KLEM Radio.
At Arnold Motor Supply in Lamar's, they understand service really does make the difference. They'll take the extra step to help you find the right part. The first time, every time. At Arnold Motor Supply, service really is the difference.
We're proud to be Arnold Motor Supply.
MRK Insurance knows that teamwork is dream work. At MRK Insurance, you get a great partner for all of your insurance needs. Visit them today on Central Avenue in Lamar's for a no-obligation quote for all of your insurance needs. That's MRK Insurance in Lamar's. State Farm agent Michael Crank is a proud supporter of local athletics. Whether you are looking for auto, home, or health insurance, choose the agent that will be on your side. State Farm agent Michael Crank.
This is Kale Pearson, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
And we welcome you back here to Harold Wood Field in Marcus. It's Class A District 1 action, and MMCRU has gotten things started off right. An 8-play, 74-yard drive in a little over 4 minutes, capped off with a 28-yard touchdown pass, 46 to go in the first quarter. And it'll be Mitchell Schneff ready to boot this one away. A line drive toe poke that is heading toward the sideline. It rolls out of bounds at the 10. And so Gehlen Catholic is going to get some good field position up to their own 35-yard line to get started with their first possession of the night. We'll see how the Jays try and improve things here after last week getting shut out by Hinton. Never the way you want to start a season, that's for sure. with a loss number one and then a loss in which you don't score any points. But Coach Schindler is ready to hopefully right the ship offensively. And Gehlen Catholic's going to start at their own 35. Cole McCarty, the quarterback, takes over for the Jays. He threw five passes last week. They were pretty content to run the football with Cale Pearson to the tune of 120 yards. Cole McCarty lines up in the pistol. A trip receiver set right, one left. A knee-high snap, and he gives it. Left side, Cale Pearson has some room up the sideline to the 45-50. Gets a block to the outside, 45-40, 35-30, and deep into Royal territory goes Cale Pearson. What a run for Cale Pearson. They're going to mark him down just shy of the red zone at the 25-yard line. Boy, that is a 40-yard carry for Cale Pearson. It'll be first and 10 for the Jays right away at the Royal 25. Well, that's one way to get things started offensively for Gehlen Catholic, all the way close to the red zone of MMCRU at about the 25-yard line. So first and 10 for the Jays. Three receivers right, one left. McCarty in the pistol look. He takes the snap. They go back to the well with Pearson. Carries up the middle. He's got Green again to the 20. 15 lowers his shoulder, and he's got another Gehlen Catholic first down. A gain of 10 into the red zone of the 15-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Jays. But this was where they were able to move the ball fine last week. In between the red zones, the Jays moved the ball well, very well. But, of course, when you don't score, it kind of takes a toll on the fact that, yeah, you moved the ball well toward the red zone but couldn't take advantage. See if the Jays could take advantage and get score number one in 2023. First and 10 of the MMCRU 15. Cole McCarty takes the snap. He gives left side on a counter. It's Pearson now turning up the middle. 10 to the 5. Breaks a tackle. He's all the way into the end zone. It's a Gehlen Catholic touchdown. Cale Pearson scores the first touchdown of 2023. It's a 15-yard scamper up the middle. Three carries for 65 yards for Cale Pearson on that drive. And it is a 7-6 ball game still in favor of MMCRU with the point after pending. Boy, what a drive. Cale Pearson goes three carries, 65 yards, caps it off with a 15-yard touchdown run. And now to be Dylan Pacus trying for the point after try to tie the game. Snap and the hold by Landon Ryder. The line drive boot by Pacus is through the uprights and good. And just like that, 6:58 to go here in the first quarter. We are tied now, MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic at 7 apiece. We'll take a break, come back with more Gehlen Catholic and MMCRU football after this from Marcus here on KLEM.
Timmons Construction believes leadership, teamwork, communication, training, planning, attention to detail, dedication, and work ethic make athletic teams successful. Timmons Construction also realizes those same qualities are the necessary ingredients for a successful business. Timmons Construction is proud to sponsor this sports broadcast.
The Lamars Knights of Columbus Council 1466 would like to wish our teams the best of luck in the game. The Knights of Columbus is proud to support our schools and many charities throughout the year with our pork chop dinners and fish fries. Check out upcoming events by visiting their Facebook page at Lamar's KFC.
Perspective Insurance, better together. Whatever your insurance needs, call Perspective Insurance in Lamar's today at 546-7821 and make sure you are properly covered. Perspective Insurance in Lamar's, a new way to view insurance.
This is Cole McCarty, and you are listening to Jays Football on KOEM.
Well, what a start to this ball game. Both teams take their inaugural drives over 60 yards into the end zone. And with 5 minutes gone in quarter number one, we are tied between MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic to open district play. Score is 7-7 here in this ball game. A three-play, 65-yard touchdown drive capped off by a 15-yard run by Cale Pearson. Gets the Jays on the board. MMCRU with an eight-play, 74-yard drive to open this contest. Now a kickoff taken by Jace Colling. He takes it out from inside the 15. The left numbers to the 25-30. He gets wrestled down from behind by Gabe Wilton to the 36-yard line. And it'll be first and 10 now for MMCRU. They get some great field position just past the 35-yard line. So we'll see what kind of ball game this is going to be. Is this going to be a shootout? Is this going to be now that every defense has seen the other's offense, are we going to get some adjustments that slow things down? It's going to be an interesting game. Of course, Both teams played very different games last week. MMCRU and Cherokee had a long, drawn-out 74-point game combined. Gehlen and Hinton were done quickly to the tune of just 10 points being scored last week. Here's Jonah Peterson in the pistol. Three receivers right, one left. Claps his hands and takes a bell. High snap. Throws a screen pass right side in and out of the hands of Kyler Bork. It was a forward pass, and it's incomplete to bring up second down and 10. Well, that's the first incomplete pass of the night for either side. Of course, Gehlen did not throw the ball on their first drive. Good start on the first drive for Jonah Peterson. He threw four passes, completed all of them, and totaled 68 yards through the air on the first drive of the contest. So now it is second down and 10 of the 36-yard line at I formation. Peterson goes under center. He takes a snap, gives left side. That is Brayson Mulder, stood up at the line of scrimmage and finally wrestled down by Dane Lehman. Brayson at the Mulder original line of scrimmage. No gain.
No gain on the play.
And it will be now third down and 10. So the first real bit of adversity faced by either team. MMCRU had a third and 8 on their last drive. Third and 7, third and 8. That was kind of set up by a penalty in there. But they ultimately scored a touchdown on that third and 7. See what they do here on third down and 10. Peterson in the gun, two receivers right, and he takes the snap. And a three-step drop, rolls to his left, has some room to run, now throws up the sideline. Leaping catch by Jace Colling across midfield, down to the Gehlen Catholic 41-yard line. What a pitch and catch. Goes for 23 yards and a first down for MMCRU. That is incredible poise by Jonah Peterson, finding Jace Colling, the 6'3" wide receiving target. And MMCRU's got a first down to continue the drive. That is probably what eluded MMCRU for the longest time here in 11-man football, is their ability to continue and sustain drives. Now Peterson goes under center, I formation, carries left with Brayson Mulder, sheds a tackle outside the numbers and gets run out of bounds across the 40. He is down to the 36-yard line. They'll give him the 35 as well. It's a pickup of 6 for Brayson Mulder, and it'll be second down and 4 now for MMCRU. Gehlen Catholic 35-yard line with 5:50 to go in the first quarter. This ball game is tied at 7. MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic, each team trying to start off district play 1-0, and each team looking for their first win of the year. Second down and 4 from the 35. Play action fake. Peterson has time to throw over the middle. It's Kyler Bork. He hauls it in and falls down inside the 20 at the 16-yard line. About to the 16, gain of 19 on the completion to Kyler Bork. And a first down for MMCRU to the Gehlen Catholic red zone at the 16-yard line. Boy, that passing game is having all kinds of success. Outside of the low screen pass that was incomplete, this Royal passing attack has not been stopped. First and 10 now at the Gehlen Catholic 16. Two receivers left, one right. Jonah Peterson takes a snap out of the gun. He hands off the middle. It is Brayson Mulder, and he's being pushed in the middle of that pile somewhere, and he's ruled down a forward progress. He's down a forward progress at the 10. It's a gain of 6 for Brayson Mulder. And it'll now be second down and 4 as the Royals creep much closer to the red zone here in quarter number 1. Exactly 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic tied at 7. Coach Oswald mentioned this in the pregame. We'll mention it as well. MMCRU has never beaten Gehlen Catholic in football. They're looking to change that right here. Second down and 4 from the 10-yard line. High formation. Peterson gives around the right side. Mulder going off tackle. He's a race to the corner. Sheds chance. Carlson away. Dives across the 6. And he's down to the 5-yard line. He's got a first down on a gain of 5. First and goal. Now for MMCRU. Well, that's what we talked about with Jeremy Schindler in the pregame. You obviously saw, well, MMCRU threw the ball for nearly 200 yards last week, but then how do you balance that with the fact that you have to deal with a 100-yard back in the backfield as well in Brayson Mulder? I'm glad I'm not making those decisions. First down and goal here at the 5-yard line. It's a two-receiver look to the left side, tight end right. It's Jonah Peterson lined up in the gun. First and goal from the 5-yard line. Peterson takes the snap, drops back. He's being pressured. Now rolls out to his left. He's got some room to run. He gets a block up the middle, and he's into the end zone for an MMCRU touchdown. Jonah Peterson has his second rushing touchdown of the year, and the Royals go up 13-7 now with 4:12 to go in the first quarter. Jonah Peterson is into the end zone on the ground for the second time in 2023. Caps off an 8-play, 64-yard drive with six in 2 minutes and 40 seconds. And now the point after try here for Cody Evans. Try and make it an even 7-point ball game. 13-7, MMCRU. There's the snap. The spot is down, and the right-footed boot is inside the right upright. It is good. Your score, MMCRU 14, Gehlen Catholic 7 with 4:12 to go in the first quarter. Take a break. We're back with more high school football after this from Marcus here on KLEM.
Peace Pizza House is your destination before and after the game. Whether you need to feed the whole family or just looking to get out before the game, make sure to stop at Peace Pizza House. You'll find many appetizers, burgers, salads, pasta, and of course, Peace Pizza House outstanding pizza selections. Your entire family is sure to find something they're looking for. Peace Pizza House would like to wish our local teams the best of luck this season.
For all your construction needs, trust the Wilchin Brothers. They're a Better Business Bureau accredited business and will be there every step of the way to get your project done right. Call 546-4135 for Wilchin Brothers Incorporated.
This is Landon Ryder, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
We welcome you back here to Harold Wood Field in Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio with online audio at KLEM1410.com. 4 minutes and 12 seconds left to play. Here in quarter number one, we've had three total offensive drives. All three have ended in touchdowns. The score, MMCRU 14, Gehlen Catholic 7. The most recent, an 8-play, 64-yard drive for MMCRU, capped off by a 5-yard touchdown run by Jonah Peterson. Took 2 minutes and 40 seconds off the clock and put the Royals up 14-7. MMCRU has had some nice, methodical, sustained drives. Gehlen Catholic's only drive offensively took them 3 plays to get into the end zone. All 3 plays went to Cale Pearson. So we'll see if the Royals make some adjustments. Does Gehlen Catholic change things up a little bit? It'll be Mitchell Schneff who's going to boot this one away here for MMCRU. Gehlen Catholic sends Cale Pearson and Landon Ryder back. Schneff kicked one out of bounds on his only kickoff here tonight. See what happens here. He sends the line drive kick back to Ryder, fields it at the 13-yard line, takes it up to the right, numbers 25 to the 30, and he gets brought down in the pile by Noah Gallus. Gallus on the stop. First and 10 now for Gehlen Catholic. They'll start at their own 30-yard line. 4:06 to go here in the first quarter. 14-7, MMCRU up on Gehlen Catholic in Class A District 1 action. From Harold Wood Field in Marcus, we are glad you're tuned in, whether you are listening to the contest here on KLEM Radio or watching it on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel. We're happy to have you, and we thank our great video sponsors for making that possible. Easy Clean Car Wash, Peace Pizza House, Northwest Bank, and Julie Hurt, realtor at Century 21 ProLink. First and 10 from the 30-yard line. Cole McCarty lines up in the pistol, back behind him in Pearson. Gives it to Pearson. He's looking for a hole. Nowhere to go. There's a flag in there as well, and Pearson's brought down for a loss. Brought down for a loss. It was Noah Hart who was in there on the stop, but we'll await the penalty flag. As of right now, it's a loss of two. Coach Oswald's going to take the penalty. There was probably a discussion to be had. Do you want the down and the loss or just the loss of yard? But Coach Oswald will take the 10-yard penalty. Field position is very crucial in a ball game like this. So it'll be first and 20 as we back things up to the Gehlen Catholic 20-yard line. Let's thank some of our sponsors bringing you high school football here tonight on KLEM, like the Lamar's Agri Center, Advance Eye Healthcare, Cruz and Cruz Accounting, Plymouth Awards and Engraving, American Bank, as well as Clausen's Clothing, Floyd Valley Healthcare, Rexwinkle Funeral Home, Prime Bank, Premier Communications, Williams & Company, and Iowa State Bank. It is first and 10 for Gehlen Catholic. Ball spotted at their own 20 following the holding penalty. Three receivers left, one right. McCarty fakes right, gives left. It's Cale Pearson up the middle across the 25, and he's tackled down. Jace calling in there on the stop as well. As Glassmaker in there. It's a gain of 8 to the 28-yard line. And it'll be second down and 12 to go on the 8-yard carry. 3:22 to go here in the first quarter. 14-7 MMCRU. Gehlen Catholic is behind schedule now, behind the chains, and we'll see how they respond to it. Of course, Coach Schindler talked about last week they did not respond well to that challenge. Three receivers right as McCarty gives again to Pearson. Straight up the middle, he's got some green to the 30, 35, dragged from behind and finally brought down by Colling at the 37-yard line. It's a pickup of 9. It'll be third down and 3. Boy, Cale Pearson can do no wrong right now. 82 yards on just 5 touches of the football on the ground. Third down and 3 now. Maybe a short 4, if you want to call it that as well. Ball's at the Gehlen 37-yard line. Got to get across the 40 to move the chains and try and give yourself a chance to tie this ball game here in the first quarter. It'll be three receivers set to the left side, one to the right in Landon Ryder, single coverage. McCarty takes a snap, quarterback read left side. He's got a first down and more across the 40 to the 45. He's tackled down to the 47-yard line. That's a gain of 10 and a first down here for Gehlen Catholic on the 10-yard carry by number 10, Cole McCarty. First and 10 up to the Gehlen Catholic 47-yard line. So the Jays are just running the ball down the Royals' throats and just kind of trying to say, hey, figure out a way to stop it, because right now there is no way. The Royals have not been able to stop the Jay ground game. See if they can find an answer here. First and 10 of the 47-yard line. McCarty in the pistol. Three receivers set to the left. He turns, gives. Pearson up the middle, across midfield. He's got the sideline, left side 40, 35, 30. Trucks a defender to the 25, and he's finally pushed out of bounds at the 23-yard line of MMCRU. Boy, what a carry by Cale Pearson. I believe he's got about 30, maybe 29 yards on the carry, and now he is over 100 yards on the evening. 111 to be exact so far. And it is a first down easily for Gehlen Catholic to the Royal 24. Minute 44 to play here in the first quarter, 14-7. MMCRU up on Gehlen Catholic. Here in Class A District 1 action from Harold Woodfield and Marcus. First and 10, 24-yard line. Out of the shotgun, it's McCarty. Fakes the give to Pearson. He keeps right side. Sheds a tackle in the backfield. Carries for positive yardage to the 22. Pickup of 2 for Cole McCarty. And that'll bring up second down and 8. Well, as of right now, unofficially, I have Cale Pearson for 6 carries, 111 yards, and a rushing touchdown. That is beyond ridiculous right now. Second down and 8 upcoming. Ball's at the MMCRU 22-yard line. See if the Jays can get into the end zone before the end of the quarter, or if they're going to have to take this drive into quarter number 2. Minute 6 to go in the first. 14-7 MMCRU. McCarty in the gun, 2 receivers left and 1 to his right. He takes the bell high snap, fakes the give to Pearson. He's got a lot of green into the red zone, gets a block to the 15 to the 10. It's a race to the pylon. He breaks a tackle and is run out of bounds inside the 5. They're going to get him down at about the 3-yard line. Gain of 19 for Cole McCarty. It'll be first and goal at the 4-yard line. What a read on the option keep by Cole McCarty. First and goal down to the 4-yard line. And Gehlen Catholic continues to have incredible success running the football here tonight. They're already above their rushing total from last week. First and goal at the 4. McCarty in the pistol. 3 receivers out wide to the right, 1 to the left. And he takes the chest high snap, gives to Pearson, right side, lowers his shoulder. He's wrestling a defender down to the goal line. He's short at the 1 yard line. A pickup of three and a touchdown saving tackle for the moment for Jonah Peterson. And it'll be second down and goal at the one. Second down and goal at the 1 yard line. 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. The Jays do have to snap it here in quarter number one. 14-7, MMCRU leads Gehlen Catholic. Here come the Jays to the line of scrimmage on second and goal at the one. See if the Royal defense can come up big and make things a little bit more challenging. McCarty in the pistol. Three receivers wide to the left. Takes the snap. Gives up the middle. Pearson fights his way forward. He's in for a Gehlen Catholic touchdown. Cale Pearson's into the end zone for a Gehlen Catholic touchdown. His second touchdown run of the night. And just like that, it's back to a one-point ball game. It's MMCRU 14, Gehlen Catholic 13. And what a drive for the Jays. Takes 4 minutes off the clock. They run the football every time and get positive yards every time. The only time they lost yards was on a penalty on the first play of the drive. Otherwise, it was an 8-play, 70-yard drive. And now the point after try for Dylan Pacus is through the uprights and good. And with 7 seconds to go in the first quarter, it's Gehlen Catholic 14, MMCRU 14. We'll take a break and come back with more district football action from Marcus after these words here on KLEM.
Connected Electric South is your electrical headquarters for residential, commercial, and agriculture. Call for a free quote today at 546-5062. Call Connected Electric South for all your electrical needs. 546-5062.
Score big with the Sitzman Real Estate Team. Hometown realtors Shane, Peggy, Lance, and Patty are cheering the Lamar's Bulldogs and Gehlen Jays on to a victory. Buying or selling, call the Sitzman Real Estate Team today at 546-7881.
At Old Glory Roofing, they believe in the principles of hard work, integrity, and commitment. Whether you need help with roof repairs or replacements, Old Glory Roofing will provide you with the best service out there. Call them today at 712-305-8881. 8839.
This is Nolan Ellis, and you are listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
And we welcome you back to Harold Wood Field here in Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Lamar's. Online audio is found on our website at KLEM1410.com. Well, both teams have had two offensive possessions here in the first quarter. They have all ended in scores. And with 7 seconds left in the first quarter, MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic are tied at 14 in district play here in Class A District 1. MMCRU is going to get the football here off a kickoff to end the first quarter. They might get one play from scrimmage here at the first quarter before we go to quarter number two. But Gehlen Catholic finishes off an 8-play, turned into an 80-yard drive, but officially will go as a 70-yard drive in 4 minutes, and was able to get into the end zone for 6. Point after try tied us up at 14. And I think we are in for a heavyweight bout here tonight between a couple of teams who are really looking hard for their first win of the season and first win to come in district play. Dylan Pacus will boot this one away. Brayson Mulder, Jace Colling back deep to return once again for MMCRU in those all-blue uniforms. So Pacus tees it up at the 45-yard line and sends a right-footed kick. High end over end taken inside the 5 by Colling. Takes it out to the 10, 15, 20. Left sideline. He doesn't get back to the 25. He's down at the 24-yard line. And that's where MMCRU will start the drive, but it is where they will start the drive to start quarter number two. Your score after one quarter. It's MMCRU 14, Gehlen Catholic 14. Back with quarter number two from Harold Wood Field and Marcus after this break here on KLEM Radio.
South Greenview Estates is a peaceful living space located across from Willow Creek Golf Course in Lamar's. Check out their 55-plus apartments. For a private showing, call 548-7424. For more details, check out their Facebook page, South Greenview Estates in Lamar's.
You have big plans this fall, so use the equity in your home to free up some cash. Northwest Bank has three home equity loan options available. You get to choose from a fixed rate or variable rate loan. Get ready to remodel your home, buy a car, or take a vacation, whatever you want. These special loan rates are for a limited time. Apply online at nw.bank. Call 800-678-4105 for details. Northwest Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Commitment you can bank on.
The Lamar's Agri Center, your local source for Scott's lawn products, top-performing Kent feed products, a full line of agronomic inputs, bulk grass seed, bird feeders, bulk bird feed, and outstanding service. The Lamar's Agri Center, your source for everything that grows.
This is Will Harpinaw, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
Well, we welcome you back here to Haroldwood Field and Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio. Online audio at KLEM1410.com and video streaming as well on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel. Your score after 12 minutes of high school football in Marcus, Gehlen Catholic 14, MMCRU 14. The Royals had the first drive of the ball game and got things started with a touchdown. Gehlen answered with a touchdown, and then both teams answered with more touchdowns, 14 apiece after one quarter of football here in Marcus. A score update from Jim Lorenzen Field. North and Lamar's are tied at 7. Jude Doherty had the only score for the Bulldogs as of the last update. We're going to get you caught up on more Plymouth County ball games coming up on our halftime coverage. And maybe we'll try and get some Class A District 1 games as well. Of course, Akron Westfield's playing tonight, so that's one Plymouth County game, one district contest. Trying to get you caught up on HMS and Alta Aurelia. South O'Brien's playing Sheldon tonight. Trying to do all that coming up at the half. But first, it's the start of the second quarter, and there's a lot of movement on the line. And I think this is going to give the Royals some free yards. It will. Five-yard offside penalty going against Gehlen Catholic up to the 29-yard line. So it'll be first and five for MMCRU to start this possession. They get 5 free yards on the penalty. First and five now here for the Royals to start things off in quarter number two. 14 apiece between MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic. Hand goes around the left side. Brayson Mulder is lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. He stays in bounds and picks up nothing. Gain of nothing to the 29-yard line. And that's going to set up second down and five for MMCRU. So we'll see if each coach was able to use the not only the break after the touchdown late in the first quarter, but then they got another break in between quarters. We'll see if some quick adjustments were able to be made on both sides of the field. Second down and five, ball at the Royal 29-yard line. High formation, Peterson gives right side. It's Dawson Pick who carries up the right seam for a first down across the 35. He's got the 36-yard line, a pickup of 7 on Dawson Pick's first positive run of the night. And it is a first down here for MMCRU. Well, you can't be giving out, mistake penalties like Gehlen Catholic did on the offsides. It's a 6-yard carry for Dawson Pick. First down and 10 to the Royal 35-yard line. Two receivers left, one right. Peterson out of the pistol set. Knee-high snap. Drops the throw. That ball was batted up in the air at the line of scrimmage. It was either Ruland or Nellis got the hand on. I'm not sure which one. But a couple of Jays were there to bat the pass away. It falls incomplete at the line of scrimmage. Now second down and 10. Upcoming here for MMCRU. Good pass rush by the Jays. They're going to need a lot of that if they want to try and disrupt this passing attack that for the majority of this game has been unhindered. 6 of 7 passing for Jonah Peterson, 110 yards and a touchdown pass in the first quarter. Second and 10 of the 35. Peterson, play action, throws toward the left sideline. It's caught at the 41. Bork trying to turn down the sideline, and he doesn't get the first down. He's short at about the 43-yard line. Pickup of 8. That'll bring up third down and 2 on the completion to Bork.
Third and 2 for the Royals.
So a big third down here for MMCRU. That's a long 2 or a short 3, however you want to view it, with 10.5 minutes to go in the half, tied at 14. Neither team has been stopped here tonight so far. See if that changes. Third down and about 2.5 yards to go. Peterson under center, I formation, takes the snap. It's a give to the fullback, and that goes nowhere. Looked like it was John Schmellen, maybe. No, it wasn't. It was Mason Roberts. Mason Roberts on the carry. Picks up no gain. It'll be fourth down and two, and a decision upcoming for Kyle Oswald and the Royals. And they bring out John Schmellen now. He was on the sideline, and Michael Schmellen as well. Bring out Jace Colling. They take out Roberts and Michael Peterson. And it looks like the Royals are going to go for it here. Fourth down and two at the 43. Three receivers right. Jonah Peterson, the bell high snap, throws a quick pass right side. It's caught for a first down and more. Jace Collings across midfield. He's into Gehlen Catholic territory of the 43-yard line. It's a pickup of 10. A pickup of 14 for MMCRU. They only needed five, but they are overachievers here in Marcus and get a first down, big first down to keep the drive going on fourth and two. So now first and 10 to the Gehlen Catholic 43, 9:14 to play here in the first half. 14 apiece between Gehlen and MMCRU. Low snap. Peterson drops the throw. All kinds of pressure. Now he's looking to run. He's got some green to the 40. Breaks a tackle in the middle of the pile to the 36. He stays on his feet, bouncing off tackle right sideline 30. 25. Spins away from a defender. Spins from another one. And is finally going to be wrestled down at the 21-yard line. Flag comes in. A late flag comes in. Jonah Peterson lost his helmet and all of that. And if it was taken off due to a penalty, he can come back in. But if it was lost in a regular football play, it was ripped off of his helmet, so or off his head, so he's going to be able to stay on. This might be a face mask. We'll await the call. As of right now, it's a 22-yard gain to the Gehlen 21-yard line. But we got to wait the penalty flag before we can determine anything for sure. Boy, that had to be a frustrating play for the Gehlen Catholic defense. Jonah Peterson just refused to go down. He was hit multiple times. I think he even ran into our umpire. It's going to be a personal foul face mask on the Jays. It's going to be half the distance to the goal. And, it, of course, it's going to be a first down as well. So a 22-yard carry for Jonah Peterson. And then we're going to add another 10 yards up to the Gehlen Catholic 11-yard line. The face mask penalty cost things, and now Gehlen Catholic wants a timeout. With 8:54 to go in the half, Gehlen Catholic and MMCRU tied at 14. Take a short break. We're back with more after this on KLEM Radio.
Advanced Eye Healthcare, Dr. Becky DeRider knows all of our student-athletes need to keep their eye on the ball. Make sure with an eye exam at Advanced Eye Healthcare at Walmart Vision Center in Lamar's. Dr. Becky DeRider.
Certified public accountants Cruz and Cruz extend their support to all the athletes and remind everyone, in the spirit of sports, participation is more important than winning. Cruz and Cruz Accounting, proud to be a sponsor of KLEM Sports.
Plymouth Awards and Engraving is a proud sponsor of local athletics. For all of your custom awards and engraving needs, visit Plymouth Awards and Engraving at 130 4th Avenue Northeast in Lamar's. You are sure to find that perfect gift for anyone at Plymouth Awards and Engraving.
This is Gabe Wilchin, and you are listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
Well, we're about to be back here to Harold Wood Field in Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio, online audio at KLEM1410.com, video streaming as well on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel. We thank our great sponsors for that, like Pease Pizza House, Northwest Bank, Easy Clean Car Wash, and Julie Hurd, realtor with Century 21 ProLink. Gehlen Catholic called a timeout after a 22-yard carry by Jonah Peterson, plus a face mask penalty. Got the Royals down to the Gehlen 11-yard line, a net gain of 32 yards. I formation, Peterson goes under center. Two receivers left, fakes the give to the fullback. Gives left side, Brayson Mulder. He's wrestled down and brought down for a loss. Back to the 13-yard line. There were a number of Jays there on the stop. There is a flag as well, so we'll hold everything. As of right now, it's a loss of two. But that could change depending on if this is a hold I would assume it'd be a hold based on the spot of the flag and based on the angle at which it was thrown. Usually those referees and the white hats, they can see that the holding penalty much better from behind the play there. But we will see. Going to get a face mask penalty.
You have a face mask penalty.
And that penalty is accepted for 5 yards. So it'll be first down and five.
For the Royals.
So another face mask penalty against Gehlen Catholic. Now first and five here to the Gehlen Catholic 6. The Royals are in a good spot here to take the lead back. 8:42 to go in the half. Peterson the snap, throws a quick pass left side. It is caught and into the end zone for a touchdown. Kyler Pork for 6. And MMCRU goes up 20-14, 8:38 to go. Here in the first half, Kyler Bork's into the end zone for the first time tonight on a little 6-yard touchdown pass from Peterson. That's Jonah's second touchdown pass. He also has a touchdown run. And MMCRU is back on top 20-14 here in a Class A District 1 contest. Boy, what a job by the Royal offense. Take advantage of some penalties that go their way. And now they will attempt a point after try and go up by 7 with 8:38 left in the half. 20-14 MMCRU. The snap and the spot from Michael Schmellen. The kick by Cody Evans through the uprights. And it is good. Score MMCRU 21, Gehlen Catholic 14. We're back with more from Harold Woodfield and Marcus after this here on KLEM Lamar's.
At American Bank, we believe in offering you what you want in a bank. Free checking, free debit and ATM cards, extended lobby and drive-up hours, competitive loans and deposit rates, online and mobile banking with bill payment and mobile deposit services. American Bank, achieving success together for over 130 years.
Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
It's the corner for fashion. Claussen's on the corner downtown Lamar's. For men's, young men's, and ladies' clothing, a shoe department, and formal wear too. In-store alterations, gift cards, and personal service. Claussen's on the corner, downtown Lamar's.
Floyd Valley Healthcare wants you to play at the peak of your skills. Don't forget to stretch your muscles, hydrate, and schedule your wellness checks to reach your full potential. Best of luck from Floyd Valley Healthcare in Lamar.
This is Jeremy Schindler, head coach for the Gehlen Catholic football team. You're listening to Jays Football on 1410 AM, 96.9 FM, KLEM.
And we welcome you back here to Harold Woodfield and Marcus on what has turned into a beautiful night. I know we were all kind of worried that we were going to bake out here tonight, but it is gorgeous. It is warm, comparatively speaking, for the majority of nights in the high school football season, but not bad by any means. MMCRU gets into the end zone. It's a 7-play, 76-yard drive. Took 3:22 off the clock. Jonah Peterson finding Kyler Bork, and MMCRU's up 21-14 on Gehlen Catholic. It's going to be Mitchell Schneff. Line drive, right-footed end-over-end kick. This one sailing into the end zone for a touchback. Kyle Oswald's fired up on the sideline. You love to see it. I love the special teams game, and I love it when programs like MMCRU take it so seriously as well. Mitchell Schneff destroys that football into the end zone for a touchback, and MMCRU will start things off at their own, or Gehlen Catholic, excuse me, will start things off at their own 20-yard line. You would have thought that touchback was worth 20 points with the way Kyle Oswald was jumping up and down, but of course he understands field positions everything, and special teams determines field position more than anything on the football field. First and 10 here for Gehlen Catholic. They'll start at their own 20-yard line as Cole McCarty lines things up in the pistol. Cale Pearson directly behind him. Three receivers right, one left, and we've got a whistle and a flag blowing the play dead. And both lines judges saw it, so it's no dispute. It's going to be a penalty against MMCRU. Offside penalty against MMCRU. So both drives here in quarter number two start off with defensive penalties to set up first and five. First and five for the Jays here at the 25-yard line. Gehlen Catholic now with a little bit better field position anyway. Three receivers right, one left. Same formation in the pistol as McCarty. Pearson directly behind him, and McCarty takes the belt high snap. Play action, bootleg, rolling out to his left. He's looking to throw. He just throws it away. Throws it up the sideline, out of bounds, and incomplete. No intentional grounding, of course. It'll be second down and five. Yeah, that rule, the tackle box rule, the throw past the sideline rule, that has been in Iowa high school football for the last 3 or 4 years. But the new change is that is a nationwide implementation in the National Federation of High School Sports, that is going to be the intentional grounding rule. Iowa became kind of a pioneer of that in allowing the high school quarterback to run outside the tackle box. Pistol look, they give it this time for Pearson, who's got a first down across the 30, spun around and brought down across the 35 to the 36. A pickup of 11. And Cale Pearson keeps the beat going for a Gehlen Catholic first down. Gain of about 10 yards there for Cale Pearson. First down and 10 here for Gehlen Catholic. 8:15 to go in the first half. 21-14, MMCRU leading this ball game. Of course, MMCRU got the football first. They've had more finished offensive possessions to this point, and it seems like that's going to be how this game's determined. Whoever has the ball last is going to win this game, I think, as of right now. At least it's trending that way. McCarty lines up in the pistol, gives right side on the counter. Pearson carries up the middle to the 40, sheds a tackle to the 41, and he's brought down to the 42. It's a pickup of 7 yards for Cale Pearson of the Gehlen Catholic 42. Be second down and three. Second down and three upcoming here for Gehlen Catholic at their own 42. And once again, the running game is just a freight train right now. 162 yards on the ground on just 13 running plays. 13 running plays totaling 162 yards. The entire team is averaging over 10 yards a carry. Second down and two to go from the 42. McCarty rolling out left. He's running to the 45, and he is just shy of the line to gain. It's going to be third down and about a foot. Third down and about a foot, and now a Galen Jay injured on the play. A Jay down on the field and slow to get up after the play ran to that left sideline. So we will await the injured Jay. Maybe just a cramp or something like that. Of course, it is still warm today, but of course, now the Gehlen Catholic training staff heads over to the near side and attending to the injured Jay. Currently, it is third down and about a foot to go. It's 7:03 in the first half. It's 21-14 MMCRU. We will take a short break, and we will come back with more high school football from Harold Wood Field in Marcus. You're listening to 1410 AM and 96.9 FM, KLEM.
Hey, Bobby Blazer, how long you been waiting in that line? Head over with me to Easy Clean Car Wash. They're going to get you in and out in no time and make that black coat of yours look like $1 million.
Say, thanks there, Mickey Mustang. I've been out four-wheeling. I got lots of mud and stuff in my wheel wells and other places as well.
Bobby, didn't Libby Lexus tell you that Easy Clean Car Wash will pre-spray those hard-to-reach places, give you a quick massage, and make you feel and look like a whole new truck?
So that's what Libby Lexus has been up to. You know, Mickey, she's looking fine.
Easy Clean Car Wash on 12th Street, east of Hy-Vee and Lamar's.
Young and old alike enjoy the competition of high school sports. Some participate, some watch, and some remember how it was. It's only a game, but it offers great life lessons and memories that last a lifetime. A few thoughts from Dan and Lori Rexwinkle of Rexwinkle Funeral Homes in Lamar's and Akron.
Prime Bank is pleased to support educational opportunities at Gehlen Catholic and Lamar's community. We're proud to support our students in the classroom, on the playing field, in the band room, on stage, or in any extracurricular activity. Prime Bank works hard to help all of our children excel in their endeavors.
Member FDIC.
Make sure your life runs smoothly with an upgraded internet package from Premier Communications, connecting you with the internet speed and television access package that best fits your wants and needs. Premier Communications is happy to support our area coaches, athletes, and the parents who support them. Have a great season.
This is Chance Kelson, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
Well, Chance Carlson heading off of the field after doing something to his leg on the last play. He also welcomes you back to the broadcast here tonight. It's 21-14. MMCRU leads Gehlen Catholic, and it looks like just kind of one of those deals that Chance had to just walk off because he was First walking with a little bit of assistance, but now he walks to the sideline under his own power. That's good to see. It's third down and a short 1 yard to go for the Jays at their own 45-yard line. See if Gehlen goes to the well again of the ground game. The Royals are stacking the box. McCarty gives to Pearson straight up the middle, and the Royals sniffed it out. He goes down for a loss back to the 43-yard line. It's a loss of two, and it'll now be four down and three for Gehlen Catholic, and a decision is upcoming for Jeremy Schindler, head coach of the Jays. That's the first rushing play to lose yards, by the way, for Gehlen Catholic here tonight. The Royals, I think, had eight guys in the box just ready for the run. They knew it was coming. And now fourth down and three, maybe a short two, somewhere around there, as Gehlen Catholic tries to keep the drive going, or are they going to elect to punt? They're going to take this play clock down, and Jeremy Schindler is going to call a timeout. With 1 second left on the play clock, he calls it with 6:08 to go in the first half. Trying to give the Jays some more time to think about what the play call is coming up with here. 6:08 to go in the half, 21-14 MMCRU. A big fourth down and about three to go for Gehlen Catholic when we come back here on KLEM.
Williams & Company, Certified Public Accountants, congratulates all area athletes in support of excellence, good sportsmanship, and the spirit of teamwork. A proud sports sponsor, Williams & Company, CPAs, your full-service business advisor with a local office in Lamar's.
Being on the winning team in Northwest Iowa for over 130 years, Iowa State Bank is a proud supporter of all our area high school sports teams.
Iowa State!
Hi, this is Julie Hurt with Century 21 ProLink in Lamar's, your local real estate expert dedicated to results. Whether buying or selling a home, call me, Julie Hurt, with Century 21 ProLink in Lamar's at 540-7757. That's 540-7757.
This is Kale Pearson, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
We welcome you back here to Harold Woodland Marcus, Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio. And online at KLEM1410.com with a video stream as well on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel. It is fourth down and a long two, short three. 6:08 to go in the first half. 21-14 MMCRU. Jays are going for it. McCarty's in the pistol. Three receivers left, one receiver right, and another timeout is used by Jeremy Schindler, head coach of the Jays. He did not like what he saw, and that is the last timeout of the first half here for Gehlen Catholic. They've used all three. MMCRU has used none. So we'll take another break. We'll come back. More high school football coming your way from Marcus after this here on KLEM.
LSI Staffing has one mission: to match employers with great employees. If your manufacturing business is looking to partner with an industry leader, LSI Staffing is worth the call. Call them today at 712-202-2850.
Gehlen Catholic School, excellence in education, leadership through Christ. For information, check their website at gehlencatholic.org.
This is Cole McCarty, and you are listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
Well, a lot being invested into this fourth down play as we welcome you back here to Marcus. Gehlen Catholic has used two timeouts in preparation for this fourth down play. And I think the question for Coach Schindler is, do they want to go to the passing attack, or can they find some way to wrinkle the run game? Well, they're not going to go for it now. They are going to line up to punt this one away, and for the first time here tonight, as of right now, a defense has come up with a stop. Right now, the Jays lined up to punt it, and Landon Ryder takes the snap. It's a rugby-style kick. He runs it far and then gets it away late. It's going to bounce to the 34-yard line of MMCRU and take a little bit of a J roll. It's down at the 32-yard line. And so MMCRU will take over the football with 5:57 to go in the first half. They'll start things off at their own 32-yard line. So kind of a tough deal for Gehlen Catholic there. They wanted to go for it and then had to burn a couple of timeouts. Wait a minute, there's a flag on this play as well. Hold on just a moment. They are moving the chain, so it probably isn't going to impact, or they weren't supposed to move the chains, I guess. Well, we are going to have a little bit of a situation to figure out here. It's fourth down and about three. And the penalty flag was thrown right at the line of scrimmage. They've got the line of scrimmage still marked over there. Got four referees conversing at about the MMCRU 35-yard line, trying to figure out, I guess, what the procedure is here. And let's see what the referee has in store for a call. It's a personal foul going against MMCRU.
Personal foul indicated against the Royals.
And it's going to be after the play, so MMCRU is going to retain the football, but they're not going to get quite as good field position. They're going to have this 15 yards back from the original spot.
Ball spotted
all
the
way back to their own 16-yard line.
First
so it had to have been something after the play that drew the ire of the officiating crew to whistle a personal foul. And so now MMCRU has their worst field position of the night, starting at their own 16-yard line. 5:57 to go in the half, 21-14 MMCRU. And Galen's going to get the ball to start the second half, so this is the big drive for the Royals. Peterson throws left side. That ball's deflected up in the air, and Bork comes down with it on a short completion for maybe a yard to the 17-yard line.
Gain of a yard on the play.
And that'll bring up second down and maybe nine. They actually put that back at about the 17. So,
ball spotted on the
no gain on the deflected pass off
Royals.
Of Gabe Wilchin at the line of scrimmage. Kyler Bork hauled it in to at least gain maybe a foot on the play. Second down and a short 10 to go for MMCRU. Peterson in the gun, takes the snap. Pitch play right. It's Mulder trying to go off tackle. It's strung out by Wilchin. He brings him down for a big loss. That's a huge play for the Gehlen Catholic defense. It's a loss of 2 yards on the carry by Brayson Mulder. It'll now be third down and a dozen with 5 minutes to go in the half. What I was saying earlier was that Gehlen Catholic is going to get the football here to start in the second half. So if MMCRU does not score here before the break, it'll be like this sequence really didn't happen. If the Royals can score now, go up by two possessions, at least you have that cushion for when Gehlen starts the second half with the ball. It's a big drive. Let's see if the Royals can not only get back ahead of the sticks, but pick up a first down here. Third and a dozen of the 15. It's Peterson dropping a throw out of the gun. That pass is deflected back to Jonah. He's completed a pass to himself. Now he's trying to run right sideline. He's still behind the line of scrimmage, trying to reverse field. He sheds a tackle back behind the 10. He's still on his feet and goes down to the 5-yard line. Jonah Peterson completes the pass to himself. He loses 7 yards to the 8. And that's going to bring up fourth down and a mile, and the Royals are going to have to punt this one back. That is incredibly bizarre. Not just that he completed the pass themselves. That's the second week in a row we've had that here on KLEM. We had that in Sergeant Bluff last week. The Warrior quarterback completed a pass to himself against the Bulldogs. So now it's fourth and a mile, and it'll be a punting scenario here for Owen Schrader. Back in his own end zone, he gets a right-footed spiraling kick. This is a beautiful punt. Ryder takes it to the 48-yard line, up the left sideline, 45 into Royal territory, and he's wrestled down from behind by Gage Johnson at about the 42-yard line. A beautiful kick by Owen Schrader. Ryder takes the return to the 42, and it'll be first and 10 for Gehlen Catholic after MMCRU has now been stopped for the first time here tonight.
First and 10 Jays.
They'll have it at about the 43-yard line. 3:30 to go in the first half. Gehlen Catholic takes over the football. First and 10 at the Royal 43. This broadcast of high school football on KLEM brought to you by Julie Hertz, Century 21 ProLink, LSI Staffing, Gehlen Catholic School, CNOS, Colbeck Hand Grinding, and Murphy Collins and McGill PLC. McCarty takes the snap, gives right side on the counter. Pearson has positive yardage across the 40, and he's tackled down to the 37-yard line. It's a pickup of about 6 yards maybe, and that's going to bring up second down at about four. So second down and four upcoming after the 6-yard carry by Cale Pearson. 3:07 to go in the half, and now Gehlen Catholic has a chance to go 2-for-1 here before the halftime break. They can score now. They'll get the ball back. See if they can take a lead to start quarter number three. It's McCarty in the gun. Pearson off his right hip. The snap rolls to him. McCarty picks it up and carries off tackle right side. He gets outside the numbers to the 30. Sheds a tackle 25. First down and more down into the red zone. He's brought down in the red zone and down at about the 19-yard line. It's a gain of about 18 yards for Cole McCarty and a Gehlen Catholic first down into the red zone of MMCRU. What a carry by Cole McCarty. So first and 10 down to the 19-yard line of MMCRU. And Gehlen Catholic with a chance to put some points on the board before the break. McCarty the low snap, gives left side Pearson. He looks off tackle as Green to the 15, to the 10, has one man to beat, lowers the shoulder, runs him over, and gets brought down by him at the 16-yard line. Taden Hicks at the 6, excuse me. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Cale Pearson to the MMCRU 6-yard line. So at the MMCRU 6, just outside the 6 maybe. Now first and goal for the Jays, trying to put points on the board before the break. 2:08 to go in the half. And Cole McCarty leads his team to the line of scrimmage. Three receivers right, one left. Pistol set with Pearson directly behind him. McCarty, bell high snap, gives to Pearson straight up the middle. He's grabbed by Brayson Mulder, drags Mulder to the 5, and brought down right at the 5. It's a pickup of a yard. Second and goal upcoming here for Pearson. So far, Jays have been able to move the ball well when they get close to the end zone tonight. And the question is, can that continue? Of course, that was the big problem for Gehlen Catholic last week against Hinton. They could not move the ball down inside the 10 or the 15-yard line against the Blackhawks. Got down there multiple times and were turned away multiple times. See what they got in store here on second and goal at the 5. Minute 20 to go in the half. Jays do not have timeouts, remember. McCarty's in the pistol, takes the snap, gives right side. It's Pearson. He lowers his shoulder. He gets stood up at the 4-yard line, just a gain of maybe a yard. Not really a yard. No gain on the carry for Cale Pearson. Third down and goal upcoming. And can the Jays find a way to add a wrinkle to their run game? Right now, I think everybody in this facility knows the Jays are going to run the football. But the question is, can they disguise it well enough to throw the Royals off for just a moment? Third down and goal at the 5. Another shotgun set here for McCarty. Three receivers right. He takes the snap. It's an option. He's got the pitch if he wants it. Outside the numbers, down toward the goal line. He's tackled into the end zone for a Gehlen Catholic touchdown. Cole McCarty is into the end zone, and the Jays have made it a one-point ball game with just 32 seconds left to play before halftime. Cole McCarty rushes one in for the first time this year. A point after try upcoming that will tie the game with 32 seconds left in the first half.
Number 5, Dylan Pacus.
Of course, it could end up just taking us into the break as well. MMCRU does have 3 timeouts, so they could get interesting offensively. Dylan Pacus makes the point after try, and this ball game is tied at 21 with 31.8 seconds left to go here in the first half. We'll take a break, come back, and the kickoff comes your way next here on KLEM.
A home is a safe place to be, a roof over your head, and 4 walls to keep out the heat and cold. It's a child's laughter, a mother's song, and a father's strength. It's where we go for comfort and to share joy. It's your first school and your first church. It's where memories are shared. Hi, this is Julie Hurt, your Century 21 ProLink real estate agent. Whatever a home means to you, I am here to help you find the home you are looking for. Call 540-7757 and let me, Julie Hurt, help you make a house your new home.
This is Landon Rader, and you are listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
And we welcome you back here to Harold Woodfield and Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio with online audio at KLEM1410.com. We have a tie ball game here with 31.8 seconds to go in the first half. MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic tied at 21. Well, it's Cale Pearson with a couple of touchdown runs. Cole McCarty got the last touchdown run for Gehlen Catholic. Jonah Peterson, two touchdowns through the air, one on the ground. And now MMCRU is going to have an interesting opportunity if Coach Oswald wants to try and take advantage of this. They have all three timeouts, 32 seconds left to go. Galen's going to get the football to start the second half. So if the Royals can march their way downfield and get some points before the break, that would be wonderful for MMCRU. Dylan Pacus sends a right-footed end-over-end kick back, and it is taken by Schmellen at the 21-yard line. Up the left seam to the 30, and he stood up past the 30 to the 32-yard line. 26 seconds left to play in the half. Again, Coach Oswald does have all three timeouts left. So how do the Royals want to play this? Do they just want to take this into the break? I would doubt it. At least see what happens on first down, I think, is going to be the way to go about things here for Coach Oswald and the Royals. First and 10 from about the 32-yard line, 26 seconds left in the half, tied at 21. Royals with all three timeouts. Peterson in the pistol. He takes a knee-high snap, bobbles for a moment, recovered. Now he rolls out to his right, chased to the sideline, and throws short of Kyler Bork, and incomplete. That took 6 seconds off the clock. 20 seconds left to play in the first half. No timeout used. Didn't have to use it, of course, with the incomplete pass. Tied at 21. Gehlen does not have any timeouts, of course. I'm sure they would not want to use any in this scenario, obviously. 20 seconds to go in the first half, tied at 21. MMCRU now is second and 10 at the 32-yard line. Coming up at the halftime break, run down your first half stats, get you caught up on the action you've missed so far, and try and get some scores from around Northwest Iowa and Plymouth County as well, all coming up at the half. On second and 10, Peterson takes a low snap again, drops back to throw. He's sacked from behind. He lost the football, but he was dropped right on it. At the 24-yard line, it looked like, was it Gabe Wilchin off that right side? It was Gabe Wilchin who comes up with a sack, a huge sack, and that is going to take us into the halftime break. Your score after 24 minutes of football, it's Gehlen Catholic 21, MMCRU 21. We have settled nothing through the first half of this ball game. Gehlen Catholic will get the football to start the second half. We will take a break, come back. When we do, we'll have your first half stats, a drive summary, break down the action for you. We'll also get you caught up on some scores from around Northwest Iowa as best we can. That's all coming up on our halftime coverage. Again, the score from Harold Woodfield and Marcus, it's Gehlen Catholic 21, MMCRU 21 in the opener of district play in Class A District 1. We'll take a break, come back. Halftime coverage up next here on KLEM Lamar's.
Success is born of skill and team. Like the teams playing, CNOS has combined award-winning skill and teamwork into the premier medical facility in the region. For the areas of joint, bone, muscle, nerve, and brain are treated with the skills of comprehensive care from a team of highly trained experts. And CNOS takes care of many of the student athletes in Siouxland. CNOS is proud to bring you this game. Go to CNOS.net to learn more.
Colbeck Incorporated is proud to support local high school athletics. They encourage you to play hard and play smart and always show good sportsmanship. Best of luck from your friends, Brian, Kevin, and Wayne Colbeck.
Murphy Collins and McGill PLC in Lamar's supports our local student athletes, trusted for generations with reliable legal guidance. So when you are in need of legal services, consult with one of the attorneys at Murphy Collins and McGill PLC, located at 38 First Avenue Northwest, Lamar's, Iowa.
Peace Pizza House is your destination before and after the game. Whether you need to feed the whole family or just looking to get out before the game, make sure to stop at Peace Pizza House. You'll find many appetizers, burgers, salads, pasta, and of course, Peace Pizza House outstanding pizza selections. Your entire family is sure to find something they're looking for. Peace Pizza House would like to wish our local teams the best of luck this season.
Kemp's Dairy of Lamar's is a proud supporter of area athletics. They focus on strong, healthy bodies with all their dairy products. And they continue to strive hard to provide the best possible dairy products to their customers. That's Kemp's Dairy of Lamar's.
Lamar's Community Athletic Boosters are proud supporters of this broadcast. Hard work and determination are vital to the success of our area athletics. The Lamar's Community Athletic Boosters are proud to stand behind our athletes and coaches as they work toward success on the field and in the classroom.
Get a special loan rate from Northwest Bank. Remodel your home, take a vacation, or buy a car. Use the equity in your home for what you want. Northwest Bank's home equity line of credit special of 6.99% annual percentage rate, fixed for 6 months, then variable rate thereafter. Currently 7.50% APR. Offer available for a limited time to qualified borrowers. Call 800-678-4105 for details about credit cost and terms. Apply online at nw.bank.
Commitment you can bank on.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
When it comes to service, your Lamar's Hy-Vee is number one for shopping both in-store and online. Save with the Fuel Saver Plus Perks Rewards Program at Hy-Vee, where there's a helpful smile in every aisle.
Have a great season. Huddle up and win from Noram Cold Storage, the coolest cold storage in the Midwest. Over 20 years of experience in packing, cooling, storing, and managing your products with exceptional service. Noram Cold Storage in Lamar's.
Hummer's Lawn Care Service will provide you with the services needed for the best-looking lawn in your neighborhood. Is it thatching, fertilizer, or simple maintaining of your freshly cut grass? Call Hummer's Lawn Care at 546-4087.
Hi, sports fans. This is Perry from Ace Hardware in Lamar's. We're happy to have a huge selection of what you need to efficiently maintain your home so you can find time to enjoy the game. Check out what's in the store at the new Ace Hardware downtown Lamar's.
Hi, this is Misty Zek.
This is Brock Nohava.
Hi, this is Happy Phillips.
I'm Carissa DeRocher.
This is Dave Close.
Hi, this is Austin Sitzman.
Hi, this is Jody with Exit Realty Midwest.
Exit Realty Midwest is proud to support our area athletes. Find them online at exitrealtymidwest.com.
Campbell's Rental and Repair, located on the corner of 4th Avenue Northeast and 1st Street, is a proud supporter of local athletics. For all your Toro product purchase, rental, or repair, visit Campbell's Rental and Repair today. They have a full line of Toro products for you to purchase or rent.
This is Nolan Ellis, and you are listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
And we're about to be back here to Harroldwood Field in Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio with online audio at KLEM1410.com. Your score here at the halftime break in Marcus is MMCRU 21, Gehlen Catholic 21 in the opener of district play here in Class A District 1. What a ball game it's been to this point. Let's take a look at some of the numbers. First for MMCRU, unofficially with 187 yards of total offense, 131 through the air, 56 on the ground. Jonah Peterson is 10 of 13 passing for those 131 yards, two passing touchdowns. Found Gage Johnson for a 28-yard score. Kyler Bork's having a great night so far. Five catches, 53 yards, and a receiving touchdown. Four catches, 57 yards for Jace Culling as the other favorite target for MMCRU. On the ground, Jonah Peterson has three carries for 19 yards and a rushing touchdown. Brayson Mulder, nine carries on the ground for 31 yards and a score. No score for MMCRU. He's been touching the football a ton and been able to move the ball well, but not quite got into the end zone on the ground for him yet. For Gehlen Catholic, it has been all running the football and nothing more. The Jays have 206 yards of total offense. Every single inch of those 206 yards of offense have come on the ground. Cale Pearson right now, 15 carries for 150 yards and two rushing touchdowns. It is Cole McCarty, six carries, 56 rushing yards, and a rushing touchdown as well for Cole McCarty here in the contest tonight. So that is how the stats break down. And right now, not a whole lot going for the Jays through the air, of course. And we take a look at the drive summary to this point. MMCRU got the football first. It was an 8-play, 74-yard drive that took 4 minutes and 7 seconds off the clock. Jonah Peterson found Gage Johnson for a 28-yard score, made things 7-0 early. Then the second drive of the game for Gehlen Catholic, it went 65 yards on 3 plays, and Cale Pearson punched it in from 15 yards out. That made it 7-7. MMCRU's ensuing drive goes 8 plays for 64 yards and a 5-yard touchdown run for Jonah Peterson, made it 14-7. And then the last drive of the first quarter was a nice one for Gehlen Catholic. 8-play, 70-yard drive, a 1-yard touchdown run for Cale Pearson capped it off in 4 minutes, and that made things 14-14 after one quarter. The first drive of quarter number two results in 6 for MMCRU, 7-play, 76-yard drive. Jonah Peterson finds Kyler Bork for a 6-yard pitch and catch, and it was 21-14. Then we had a punt for Gehlen Catholic. They had one first down on that drive. MMCRU goes 3 and out, sets up the Jays with some great field positions, starting at the Royal 43-yard line, and they take advantage on a 5-play, 43-yard drive. A 5-yard touchdown run for Cole McCarty finishes off the 3-minute drive and ties the ball game up at 21. And that's how things would go into the half. The Royals had a couple of plays on offense to send us into the break. Gabe Wilchin finished it off with a big sack of Jonah Peterson. Of course, the opening coin toss was won by MMCRU. They elected to receive the football. So we'll see Gehlen Catholic out there to start the second half, and that is huge. We talked about that a little bit with MMCRU. They were going to get a chance there to try and take the lead after Gehlen had to punt them the football. A chance to drive downfield, maybe score to try and take away any opportunity for the Jays to tie the game at the break. But now, of course, the Jays have tied it already in the first half, and we'll have a chance to take the lead right away. I think it's going to come down to who's going to get the football last here tonight and is going to be successful and win this ball game. But that is still TBD. Of course, Galen's got themselves in a good spot. They can take their first lead of the night here in the second half if they can play their cards well. And they got to find some way to either disguise their running game a little bit better. They've been going to the counter game, which has worked a number of times here tonight. But they got to do something else, throw some kind of other wrinkle into that running scheme. Otherwise, it's just going to be MMCRU bringing pretty much 8-9 guys into the box like we've seen them do at times already tonight. And Galen's not going to be able to run the football. And when MMCRU is able to commit everything to the run like they have been on that fourth down play, we saw that, or that third down play that set up the fourth down play. And when they do that, they have been tremendously successful. And right now, they can pretty much do that because Gehlen Catholic right now is of no threat to throw the football. So going to be interesting what kind of adjustments are made. Does Gehlen Catholic start going through the air? Does MMCRU start walking up safeties into the box? I mean, they've already done it. But it's going to be really interesting to see what both coaches, two outstanding head coaches and coaching staffs, see what they draw up. Because, of course, this is a big game. It's a district ball game. You definitely want to start district play 1-0, especially when 4 out of your 7 teams in your district make the playoffs. One win is so huge in your ability to make the postseason. Of course, MMCRU motivated. They have never beat Gehlen Catholic in high school football. So it is going to be a 21-21 ball game here at the halftime break. Let's take another timeout, and when we come back, we'll run down some scores we're able to track down for you from around Plymouth County. We've got a couple of them already, and we'll try and track down some more. When we come back to Harold Woodfield and Marcus, you're listening to high school football here on KLEM Radio.
Sulan Glass is so glad you're supporting local athletes and listening to this great matchup. Sulan Glass wants me to tell you that if you have a chip or crack in your windshield or need the whole thing replaced, you can call them at 540-9080. Sulan Glass!
Get more because you deserve more with Kylie Petty, Century 21 Pro Link, serving Lamar since 2011. Wishing our local teams a successful season. Visit KylePetty.com for your real estate needs.
For all of your commercial or residential concrete or construction needs, JMAX Construction is ready for you. At JMAX Construction, you can be sure that your project will be handled with great customer service as well as the best of class construction and concrete work. Call JMAX Construction and Concrete today at 540-0574.
Hi, Jessica G.
Well, hello, Libby Lexus.
I'm so excited to get the spa treatment at Easy Clean Car Wash. My owner knows how much I love the soft water. Oh, and the quick massage just makes my bumpers tingle.
And the blow dry is to die for. It always leaves my exterior sleek and shiny.
My owner bought me a year pass so I can have the spa treatment anytime I want.
Hey, ladies.
Ooh, nice tires.
Oh, Mickey Mustang, you're such a player.
Easy Clean Car Wash. Give your car the spot treatment today. 12th Street east of Hy-Vee Lamar's.
At Universal Windows Direct, you're not just purchasing windows, you're also getting peace of mind, knowing that their knowledgeable local staff is there for you every step of the way. You receive quality Unishield products along with a limited lifetime warranty to ensure that you're taken care of for years to come. Universal Windows Direct wishes all local athletes the best of luck.
At Arnold Motor Supply in Lamar's, they understand service really does make the difference. They'll take the extra step to help you find the right part. The first time, every time. At Arnold Motor Supply, service really is the difference.
We're proud to be Arnold Motor Supply.
A home is a safe place to be. A roof over your head and four walls to keep out the heat and cold. It's a child's laughter, a mother's song, and a father's strength. It's where we go for comfort and to share joy. It's your first school and your first church. It's where memories are shared. Hi, this is Julie Hurt, your Century 21 ProLink real estate agent. Whatever a home means to you, I am here to help you find the home you are looking for. Call 540-7757 and let me, Julie Hurt, help you make a house your new home.
MRK Insurance knows that teamwork is dream work. At MRK Insurance, you get a great partner for all of your insurance needs. Visit them today on Central Avenue in Lamar's for a no-obligation quote for all of your insurance needs. That's ours. State Farm agent Michael Crank is a proud supporter of local athletics. Whether you are looking for auto, home, or health insurance, choose the agent that will be on your side. State Farm agent Michael Crank.
Timmons Construction believes leadership, teamwork, communication, training, planning, attention to detail, dedication, and work ethic make athletic teams successful. Timmons Construction also realizes those same qualities are the necessary ingredients for a successful business. Timmons Construction is proud to sponsor this sports broadcast.
The Lamar's Knights of Columbus Council 1466 would like to wish our teams the best of luck in the game. The Knights of Columbus is proud to support our schools and many charities throughout the year with our pork chop dinners and fish fries. Check out upcoming events by visiting their Facebook page at Lamar's KFC.
Perspective Insurance, better together. Whatever your insurance needs, call Perspective Insurance in Lamar's today at 546-7821 and make sure you are properly covered. Perspective Insurance in Lamar's, a new way to view insurance.
This is Will Harpenaugh, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
Well, we welcome you back here to Harold Woodfield and Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio, MMCRU and Gehlen Catholic. They are tied at 21 in the opener of district play. What a ball game we've been treated to so far. And we're gonna see if it continues that way. It's going to be a one heck of a finish. Again, the score tied at 21. Gehlen Catholic's going to start the second half of action with the football, but before they do, let's get you some scores from around Northwest Iowa that we have been able to track down. We'll start with our Plymouth County scores. At the halftime break, Lamar's Community leads Sioux City North 21-7. It is ninth-ranked Logan Magnolia leading Kingsley Pearson 21-12. Akron Westfield is up on Sibley Ocheden. That score 32-18 at the break. This is midway through the third quarter. Western Christian leads Hinton 19-0. And top-ranked Remsen St. Mary's blowing out Siouxland Christian 36-0. That contest is at the halftime break in Sioux City. Some other scores of note, at least for right now, in Class A, District 1. The score reported right now has Alta Aurelia up 2-0 on Hartley Melvin Sanborn. Not sure if that's entirely accurate or not, but again, that is the score we have. Has Alta Aurelia up on Hartley Melvin Sanborn 2-0 at the break. Sheldon leads South O'Brien by a score of 14-0. At the halftime break there. Some other scores we can pass along to you if we can try tracking some down. Let's see. Here we go. Sioux Center leads Spirit Lake. That score is 16-14 in quarter number three. Central Lyon George Little Rock, the number two team in Class 2A. They lead MOC Floyd Valley 20-0. Cherokee is destroying Sioux Central 37-0 at the halftime break. Bishop Heelan's doing the same over Council Bluffs Abe Lincoln. That score is 50-0 at the halftime break. Boyden-Hall Rock Valley, this is a team we're going to see next week on KLEM Radio. The Nighthawks lead West Sioux big time at the halftime break. It's 27-6 in Haywarden. Woodbury Central, third ranked in Class A. They lead Westwood 13-7. West Lyon is destroying Lawton Bronson 43-6 at the break. Boone's taking it to Storm Lake 30-0 at the half. And any other Northwest Iowa scores we can find for you. Sioux City West playing South Sioux. No score of that one. And that is all we've got for you. Some very interesting scores to this point at the halftime break. And of course, make sure you tune in to our sports updates tomorrow during the 7:20 and at 12:45. And also at the start of the KLEM Coaches Corner, we'll run down all the scores we were able to track down. Of course, if you can't wait until then, be sure to keep the KLEM Sports Scores and Results page refreshed throughout the night, as we are going to keep you up to date on all of those as they come into the KLEM Sports Department. We mentioned Akron Westfield's leading Sibley Ocheden 32-18 at the halftime break. That's a perfect segue to mention to you that we are going to plan on, in addition to Ken Vigdahl and Jeremy Schindler on the Coach's Corner tomorrow, we're going to plan on tracking down John Sievert, the head coach of Akron Westfield football. So make sure you tune in for that. We'll have Ken Vigdahl on first in the 8 o'clock hour. We'll have Jeremy Schindler on second, and John Sievert will join us later on in the 8 o'clock hour as we talk all things Plymouth County football with three outstanding head football coaches. Well, it is time to start the second half. Again, the score, Gehlen Catholic 21, MMCRU 21. What is going to give as we get ready for quarter number three of this contest? A couple of teams who have pretty much mirrored each other. I mean, there's no better way to put it. Touchdowns breed touchdowns. Punts have bred punts. The second punt, anyway, bred a score for Gehlen Catholic. So we'll see what comes of this second half opening drive. Again, Gehlen Catholic and MMCRU tied at 21. Jays are going to get the football here to start the second half. Mitchell Schneff drove a touchback through the end zone on his last kickoff. And so we'll see if he can do it again. It fired up Kyle Oswald on the sideline. Let's see what he has in store for this kickoff. Jays send Cale Pearson, Landon Ryder back to return, and Mitchell Schneff gets the line drive toe poke into it, and Pearson takes it from outside the 10-yard line. Takes a right sideline to the 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. He's got some room across midfield. There's a flag on the play. Pearson takes this one to the house, but this one's going to be coming back. Cale Pearson runs a touchdown all the way back of the kick return, but a penalty flag is back at the Gehlen Catholic 40-yard line. It is a hold going against the Jays, so this will set things up for MMCRU at their own, or for Gehlen Catholic at their own 30-yard line. Well, Pearson had a crease up the sideline, and now, of course, we know that crease was penalty-aided. But he hit that sideline and got a burst of energy. He had a second wind on his way into the end zone. But the holding penalty negates the score. And so now it is first and 10 for Gehlen Catholic. They will start this drive back at their own 30-yard line. So first and 10 for the Jays at the 30-yard line. Let's see what kinds of things the Jays come out with here offensively. Gehlen Catholic has run the football, and then they've run the football some more. See if they do that again. Do they change things up a little bit with how they are trying to run the ball here tonight? Going to be interesting to see, and see maybe what kind of adjustments MMCRU makes as well on the defensive end. First and 10 here for Gehlen Catholic from their own 30-yard line. They'll line up on the right hash. Cole McCarty in the pistol with Cale Pearson behind him, has three receivers wide to the left, one to the right, and McCarty takes the first snap of the second half, gives around the left side. It is Pearson going off tackle, and he gets maybe a yard as the Royals strung that play out and brought him down at the 31-yard line, and AJ is slow to get up on the play. All the way on that far side of the field. Just a yard for Cale Pearson. We'll set up second and 9, but we do have a dinged up Jay on the other side of the field. So we will see who it is. Looks like a wideout. It might be Chance Carlson again. No, it's not. Okay, it's not. I never want to guess. It is not Chance Carlson. So we'll see. We can't see the number right now. But with 11:35 to go in the third quarter, Gehlen Catholic and MMCRU are tied at 21. We'll take a short timeout with this injured player on the field and be back with more after this, right here on KLEM Radio.
For all your construction needs, trust the Wilchin Brothers. They're a Better Business Bureau accredited business and will be there every step of the way to get your project done right. Call 546-4135 for Wilchin Brothers Incorporated.
Connected Electric South is your electrical headquarters for residential, commercial, and agriculture. Call for a free quote today at 546-5062. Call Connected Electric South for all your electrical needs. 546-5062.
Score big with the Sitzman Real Estate Team. Hometown realtors Shane, Peggy, Lance, and Patty are cheering the Lamar's Bulldogs and Gehlen Jays on to a victory. Buying or selling, call the Sitzman Real Estate Team today at 546-7881.
This is Gabe Wilchin, and you are listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
Well, we welcome you back here to Harold Wood Field in Marcus. Dylan Pakus, the injured Jay, getting up onto his feet and walking off the field under his own power. A good sight to see. No assistance on his way to that far side of the field. Now the Jays will have to make a change at tight end. 11:35 to go in quarter number three. Gehlen Catholic and MMCRU are tied at 21 in the opener of district play in Class A District 1. It's going to be second down and a long nine once Pakus is safely on the sideline. He now is. Was dinged up earlier on in the ball game. He's been out there now, and that's a good sight to see. Three receivers line up wide to the right, one to the left. It is McCarty in the pistol, Pearson directly behind him. McCarty the snap, counter give right side. It's Pearson breaking through the middle. He's got a first down across the 35 to the 40-yard line, down to the 41. He's got 10 yards and a first down for Gehlen Catholic. Well, the beat does go on here for Gehlen Catholic, a 10-yard carry straight up the middle for Cale Pearson. First down and 10 here for Gehlen Catholic to the J 41-yard line. Lamar's Community has taken a 28-7 lead on Sioux City North. Getting updates from that contest. First down and 10 here at the 41-yard line. Three receivers right, one left. It is McCarty giving up the middle, and it is Pearson carrying forward across the 45. He's tackled forward, taking some momentum to the 47-yard line. And just the 46, gain of five for Cale Pearson. Now second down and five upcoming. So Gehlen Catholic wants nothing more than to take a lead here. They got an opportunity in front of them after MMCRU chose to take the football first to start this ball game. Gehlen Catholic getting it to start the second half, tied at 21. 10-12 to play in the third. Second down and five of the 46. Three receivers right. McCarty's in the pistol. He takes the bell high snap. Fakes the give. Bootleg left. He's looking to throw. He just barely gets it away. Did that ball get past the line of scrimmage? That's the question. It bounced about a yard in front of the line, it looked like. The ball did get past the line of scrimmage. It's an incomplete pass. Third down and five upcoming. That was very close. Normally, we have to talk about the pass going in front of the line of scrimmage when the ball's thrown out of bounds, but that one was thrown upfield. And maybe there was a receiver in the area as well. Not sure, but regardless, it is not intentional grounding. But it is third and five after McCarty barely had that pass gotten away after taking a hit. Third and five of the 46. And three receiver look to the right. The Royals bring a blitz. Pearson dodges the blitz. He's running up the middle, and he gets some positive yardage to the 48. It's just a pickup of two. But it is now fourth down and three here for Gehlen Catholic at their own 48-yard line. This is a very interesting spot of the field and just kind of comes down to coaching philosophy, or I guess the momentum of the game as well can contribute to this as well. But punting here kind of risks an opportunity of a touchback. You obviously can't kick a field goal. Jays are going to go for it. It's fourth down and three at the 48-yard line. Pistol look. Three receivers left, one right. McCarty gives. Pearson sheds a tackle, trying to knife his way forward. He's got a first down across midfield to the MMCRU 45-yard line. A huge pickup of 7 yards for Cale Pearson, and he's got a first down to continue the drive into Royal territory. With 9:10 to go in the third quarter, Gehlen Catholic and MMCRU remain tied at 21. Jays have first and 10 at the MMCRU 45-yard line. Huge carry by Pearson. He's got 20 touches for 175 yards and 2 scores. First down and 10 of the MMCRU 45-yard line. A 3-receiver look to the right and 1 to the left. The Royals again bring an edge rush around the right side. McCarty being chased from behind by Jace Culling. He's trying to carry off tackle and is lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. No gain for Cole McCarty. And it'll be second down and 10. Well, Jace Culling was chasing in hot pursuit from that blind side of McCarty, who was trying to run off the right side. And Culling's pressure, I think, helped make things a little bit more urgent. McCarty just ran into the defense. Now second down and 10 upcoming at the MMCRU 45 with 8:07 to play here in quarter number 3. Jays, if they're doing one thing on this drive, is they are taking a ton of time off the clock early on. Second and 10 from the Royal 45. Again, MMCRU brings a blitz. It is not picked up well, and McCarty goes down for a sack back at the 48-yard line. It's a loss of 3. A couple of Royals in on the sack to drop McCarty for a loss of 3. Now third and 13 upcoming. Dawson Pick, John Schmillen on the stop for MMCRU. Third and 13 upcoming. Jays have to get across the MMCRU 35-yard line. 7:24 to play in quarter number 3. Third down and 13 here for Gehlen Catholic at the Royal 48. 3 receivers left, 1 right. McCarty's in the pistol. He gives to Pearson left side. He's dropped for a loss of 2. The ball came out, and Mitchell Schneff is on it. Mitchell Schneff is on the loose football at midfield. The loss of 2 is accentuated by the fumble, and MMCRU will start right at the middle of the field on the first turnover of the night. 7:06 to play. They're going to have it at the Gehlen 49-yard line, actually. It's a loss of 2 for Pearson, and then he coughed up the football as well. Mitchell Schneff recovered. And now MMCRU with a prime opportunity to take another lead here. Tied at 21, 7:06 to play in quarter number 3. First and 10 for MMCRU at the Gehlen Catholic 49. An I formation here for Jonah Peterson. A receiver on either side takes the snap. Gives to Brayson Mulder. He sheds the first hit and carries for a couple of positive yards, maybe just 1 yard, to the 48. And it'll be second down and about 8 to go. They'll give him the, you know, kind of right in the middle there. To the 47. 60, Nolan Niles. So 2 yard gain, a short 2 yard gain for MMCRU. Second down and 8 up to the 47, 48 yard line of Gehlen Catholic. 2 receivers left, an I formation look for Jonah Peterson, who gets under center. Peterson takes the snap, short drop, screen pass, left side. Culling gets a great block from Bork. He sheds a tackle, 40, 35, 30, run out of bounds by Gabe Wilchin into Gehlen Catholic territory at the 30-yard line. It's a 17-yard screen pass to Jace Culling and a first down for MMCRU. Well, obviously, Jace Culling's going to get the 17 yards worth of a completion there. But Kyler Bork, if you can assist yards of any kind in high school football, Kyler Bork deserves all of those yards. He had a great seal block to the outside, gave Culling the sideline, and gave the Royals a first down to the Gehlen 30. Some movement on the line. Jays get back, and Peterson hands off the middle. It's Dawson Pick up the middle of the field to the 30, 25. He gets 5 yards, maybe 6, to the 24-yard line. And they'll give him just the 25. Gain of 5 for Dawson Pick. And it'll be second down and 5 here for MMCRU at the Gehlen 25. 5:50 to go in the third. We remain tied at 21. Nothing has budged here in this second half. A fumble by Cale Pearson on Gehlen Catholic side, the only turnover of the game. A handoff right side, Brayson Mulder has a line of green to the 15, to the 10. He stood up just short of the 10 at the 11-yard line. That's a big gain and a first down for MMCRU into the red zone of Gehlen Catholic. 13 yards on the carry for Brayson Mulder. First down and 10 to go. Now at the Gehlen Catholic 12-yard line. 5:26 to go in the third. We're tied at 21 in Class A District 1 action. Jonah Peterson. He goes under center in an I formation. Two receivers left. Peterson takes a snap. Gives left side. A big hole for Mulder. He gets tripped up. Dives toward the goal line. He's short at about the 3. Are they going to give him the first? No, they won't. Second down and 1 on the carry of 9. For Brayson Mulder, it'll be second down and 1 here for MMCRU at the Gehlen 3. So the Royals just pounding on the door of the end zone. Just a few yards away with 4:47 to play in quarter number 3. 21-21, MMCRU trying to take a lead here in the second half. Second and 1. Gehlen 3, it's a power look. 3 tight ends, I formation. Peterson gives left side, Dawson pick. He runs into a defender at the 1. He's in for a MMCRU touchdown. Dawson pick with a 3-yard touchdown run puts MMCRU up here in the second half of the ball game. Now 27-21. MMCRU leads, 4:27 left to go here in the second half. It's a 3-yard touchdown run by Dawson Pick, and Cody Evans will attempt the point after. So Cody Evans trying to put the cherry on top of the drive, give the Royals a 7-point lead with 4:27 to go in the third. Snap, spot, right-footed kick by Evans is easily through the uprights and good. Your score, 4:27 to go in the third quarter. 28-21 MMCRU. We'll take a break and come back. More high school football after this on KLEM Radio.
At Old Glory Roofing, they believe in the principles of hard work, integrity, and commitment. Whether you need help with roof repairs or replacements, Old Glory Roofing will provide you with the best service out there. Call them today at 712-305-8839.
South Greenview Estates is a peaceful living space located across from Willow Creek Golf Course in Lamars. Check out their 55-plus apartments. For a private showing, call 548-7424. For more details, check out their Facebook page, South Greenview Estates in Lamars.
The Lamars Agri Center, your local source for Scott's Lawn Products, top-performing Kent feed products, a full line of agronomic inputs, bulk grass seed, bird feeders, bulk bird feed, and outstanding service. The Lamars Agri Center, your source for everything that grows.
This is Jeremy Schindler, head coach for the Gehlen Catholic football team. You're listening to Jays Football on 1410 AM, 96.9 FM, KLEM.
And we're about to be back here to Harold Wood Field in Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio. Let's thank our sponsors bringing you an outstanding high school football game. Like Kemp's Dairy, the Lamars Community Booster Club, Hy-Vee, Noram Cold Storage, Hummer's Lawn Care, Lamar's Ace Hardware, Exit Realty Midwest, Campbell's Rental and Repair, Siouxland Glass, Kylie Petty, Realtor with Century 21 ProLink, JMAC Construction, and Universal Windows Direct. MMCRU picks up a fumble at the middle of the field, and then 6 plays, 49 yards later, Dawson Pick scores from 3 yards out to put the Royals up 28-21. Here is a bit of a squib kick. That's rolling toward the sideline. It does get out of bounds. Just before the 20-yard line, another kick out of bounds for MMCRU is going to give Gehlen the football with some good field position. With 4:27 to go in the third quarter, 28-21, MMCRU leads. I think the Jays are actually going to get this right at the 35-yard line. So first and 10 at the 35-yard line, 4:27 to go in quarter number 3. Jays have first and 10 and now find themselves behind the 8 ball again. They're down 7. 28-21 here in the third quarter. And they're kind of back to square one. Their opportunity to take a lead and kind of be in advantage of the back and forth played ball game was their first drive of the night. And now they'll need a defensive stop to try and get them back on the right track, but they need to score first. Cole McCarty in the pistol, two receivers either side, fakes the give, bootlegs right, throws in and out of the hands of Alex Peters. Looking for Alex Peters, incomplete on that right side flat, and that'll bring up second down and 10. Three pass plays for the Jays all night. They have all fallen incomplete. So it will be second down and 10 for the Jays from their own 35, 28-21 MMCRU. Pistol look here for Cole McCarty. Three receivers line up to the left, one to the right, and McCarty takes the knee-high snap, gives to Pearson straight up the middle, and we're trying to bounce off tackle. He's got nowhere to go. Cale Pearson gets wrestled down.
Stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Looked like maybe Cody Evans potentially. I know Jeremy Beck was on the stop there. No gain, they say, for Cale Pearson. That'll be third down and 10 now for Gehlen Catholic at the 35.
Jeremy Beck on the stop for the Royals.
So no gain for Pearson. Third down and 10 upcoming. 3:42 left in the third. Three receivers right. McCarty rolls to his right, throws quickly. That ball's deflected up in the air, and it falls incomplete. Looking for Landon Ryder. That ball popped up in the air and luckily went out of bounds. It's an incomplete pass. Now fourth down and 10. And Galen's probably going to have to punt this ball. They really don't want to, but this is definitely a punting scenario. 3:35 to go in the third, 28-21. MMCRU leads Gehlen Catholic. And the Royals trying to knock off Gehlen Catholic for the first time as a consolidated 11-man program. Landon Ryder goes back to boot this one away for the Jays. He sends away a rugby-style kick, right high-footed boot. It bounces at the 36, takes a royal roll, and is down at the 38-yard line. That's where MMCRU is going to start the drive. First and 10. With 3:27 to go. Sponsors like Arnold Motor Supply, MRK Insurance, State Farmer Insurance Agent Michael Crank, Timmons Construction, Lamar's Knights of Columbus, as well as Perspective Insurance, Wilchin Brothers Construction, Connected Electric South, Sitzman Real Estate Team, Old Glory Roofing, and South Greenview Estates. First and 10 here for MMCRU. Ball spotted at their own 38-yard line. The Royals line up under center with an eye formation. Handoff right side. Mulder gets off tackle. A lot of green to the 45. Midfield for a first down and into Gehlen Catholic territory at the 48-yard line. A gain of 14 for Brayson Mulder. They give him to the 47 as well. It's a 15-yard carry for Brayson Mulder and a first down for MMCRU. Well, the Royals, all they could do for a while there was throw the football, but now MMCRU is in a wonderful spot where they can pretty much do whatever they want to with the football. They can run it, they can pass it, and they can have a ton of success. First and 10 here at the Gehlen 47. Eye formation for Peterson. He hands it off right side. It's Dawson Pick now. He stood up in the pile and picks up hard-earned maybe 2 yards. We'll say the 45-yard line. That'll bring up second down and about 8 to go. Second and 8 on the 2-yard carry by Dawson Pick. Gehlen Catholic's defense really needs to stand tall now. And that's obviously a big ask of them. But it has to happen here if the Jays want to stay in this ball game. 28-21, MMCRU. Second down and 8 to go. A bootleg passing left side. Peterson pressured. He evades the pressure. Now runs. He's gotten back to the line of scrimmage. No further. Nolan Nillis there. Will Harpinaugh, Cole McCarty all there. It'll be no gain for Jonah Peterson on the carry. Now third down and 8 upcoming here for MMCRU. Gehlen Catholic 45-yard line. Yeah, Peterson had some initial pressure that really made him think twice about where he was going to throw the football. It's no gain, third and eight. Galen's defense needs a big stop here at the J45. Three receivers right of Peterson lining up in the pistol. A receiver to the narrow side, left side of the field. Bell high snap. Peterson stands in the pocket. He gets wrestled down by Dane Lehman. He's ruled down a forward progress. They whistled it down just as Jonah Peterson broke free. They're going to rule him down a forward progress of the Dane Lehman sack of the 48-yard line. It's a loss of three, and a punting scenario comes out here for MMCRU. So with a minute 12 to go and counting here in the third quarter, fourth down and a short 11 upcoming. And this is going to be a punting scenario. Owen Schrader comes out to boot it away for the Royals, and he's going to try and pin Gehlen Catholic as deep as they can. Number 60, Owen Schrader. 28-21 MMCRU, J defense. He's able to force the punt. Wilchin nearly got a hand on it. Ryder comes up, he fields it inside the 20-yard line, takes it up and barely has enough for a return. He gets brought down right at his own 20-yard line. And it is first down and 10 for the Jays at their own 20. Not much of a return, but a good job by Landon Ryder to at least field that punt and give himself a chance to not let that ball roll down inside dangerous territory. First and 10 here for Gehlen Catholic at the 20-yard line. And the Jays down 7, 28-21 here in quarter number 3. Jays need a big drive now. And it'll be Cole McCarty lining up in the gun. Two receivers on either side of the formation. Cale Pearson off his left hip. McCarty, he's running to his left. Has an option if he wants it, but keeps it. A wise choice as McCarty picks up just a couple to the 22. And that'll bring up second down and 8 for Gehlen Catholic. Back into the stands, please. So it is a pickup of 2 yards for Cole McCarty. Second down and 8 upcoming from the Gehlen Catholic 22. And it looks like the Jays are just going to take this to the fourth quarter. Well, they're going to come out and line up. There's 7 seconds left in the third. If they want to snap it here before the end of the third, they got to do so quickly. Now with 2, now with 1, Cole McCarty will not get the snap off in time. And that is the end of quarter number 3. Your score, MMCRU 28, Gehlen Catholic 21. We'll take a break, come back, and get quarter number 4 underway after this here on KLEM Lamars.
Peace Pizza House is your destination before and after the game. Whether you need to feed the whole family or just looking to get out before the game, make sure to stop at Peace Pizza House. You'll find many appetizers, burgers, salads, pasta, and of course, Peace Pizza House outstanding pizza selections. Your entire family is sure to find something they're looking for. Peace Pizza House would like to wish our local teams the best of luck this season.
Advanced Eye Healthcare, Dr. Becky DeRider knows all of our student athletes need to keep their eye on the ball. Make sure with an eye exam at Advanced Eye Healthcare at Walmart Vision Center in Lamars. Dr. Becky DeRider.
Certified public accountants Cruz and Cruz extend their support to all the athletes and remind everyone, in the spirit of sports, participation is more important than winning. Cruz and Cruz Accounting, proud to be a sponsor of KLEM Sports.
Plymouth Awards and Engraving is a proud sponsor of local athletics. For all of your custom awards and engraving needs, visit Plymouth Awards and Engraving at 130 4th Avenue Northeast in Lamars. You are sure to find that perfect gift for anyone at Plymouth Awards and Engraving.
This is Chance Kelson, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
And we welcome you back here to Harold Wood Field in Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Lamars. Online audio is found on our website as well at KLEM1410.com. You can also watch this game live on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel. And if you're listening to the game, can't watch it right now, we will have it archived on our KLEM Radio YouTube channel as well. Gehlen Catholic starts with a football, second down and a long 7 from their own 22. Cole McCarty in the pistol, two receivers either side. He takes the snap, gives it to Pearson. Left side, he's got some green. 25, trying to bounce off tackle, but a great shoestring tackle at the 26 is made by Caden Steffen. What a play, because it looked like Pearson was going to get a lot of room to run. It's a pickup of about 4 yards, and that'll set up third down and 4 here for Gehlen Catholic. Want to thank our video stream sponsors for bringing you the action on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel, like Peace Pizza House, Northwest Bank, Julie Hurd, Realtor with Century 21 ProLink, and Easy Clean Car Wash. Start of the fourth quarter, MMCRU 28, Gehlen Catholic 21, a big third down and four right away. Cole McCarty's in the pistol look, two receivers either side, takes the snap, fakes the give to Pearson, rolling to his right, being chased, he got it away, it's intercepted! MMCRU picks off the pass on the far side of the field. And it's Kyler Bork. Kyler Bork intercepts Cole McCarty and turns the Jays over for the second time here tonight. And it'll be first down and 10 for MMCRU at the Gehlen Catholic 26. What an excellent read by Kyler Bork. It is the second turnover of the night for the MMCRU defense, and now with 11-11 to go in quarter number four, MMCRU is in a wonderful spot to make it a two-score game for the first time this evening. First and 10 of the Gehlen 26. I formation, Peterson's under center, two receivers right. He takes the snap, gives a bobbled handoff, but recovered. Looks like it is Mulder in the pile. He carries for 2 yards, and it'll be second down and 8 to the Gehlen 24. Pickup of 2 yards for Brayson Mulder. Second down and 8 upcoming for the Gehlen Catholic to the Gehlen Catholic 24-yard line. So another big turnover forced by the MMCRU defense. That was one of the things that Coach Schindler said the Jays cannot do here tonight is costly turnovers. They turned the ball over a couple of times last week against Hinton as well. Second and 8, I formation, handoff left side. This is Dawson Pick now. Pick Dawson carries Pick for 2 yards to the 22. They'll give him 3 to the 21. And we third down now and 5 to go on the carry by Dawson Pick.
Looks like number 43.
So a 3 yard carry, third down and 5 upcoming for MMCRU at the Gehlen 21. Boy, if the Jays can make a stop here, that would make things very interesting on fourth down. Pistol look, three receivers, two right. Low snap, Peterson corrals, has some time. Now he's pressured. He runs to his left. He's got to evade a sack. He evades a shoestring tackle, gets inside the red zone, stops short of the line to gain on the scramble for 2 to the 19. Just a gain of 2 for Jonah Peterson. So fourth down and 3 upcoming at the Gehlen Catholic 19. And I don't think Cody Evans is much of a field goal kicker. So a big fourth down opportunity for the Gehlen Catholic defense to get off the field. Fourth down and 3, a huge fourth down with 9:15 to go in a one possession ball game in the fourth quarter. Two receivers right, one left. It's Peterson to the pistol. A knee-high snap. Throws a quick route right side. Caught by Bork for a first down. Across the 15 to the 10. He's tackled down to the 9. It's a pickup of 9 yards on the completion to Kyler Bork. It's first down and goal here for MMCRU. What a great job by everybody involved. They gave Peterson some extra time. He was able to stand tall in the pocket, go through all his progressions. Now first down and goal upcoming here for MMCRU at the Gehlen 9. 8:53 to play in the game, 28-21 MMCRU. The Royals trying to go up 2 scores. Peterson in the gun, two receivers right. He gives to Mulder, right side running, and he gets wrestled down at the line of scrimmage. No gain. Gabe Wilchin and Will Harpinaw there for the stop. It'll be second down and goal on the carry for nothing by Brayson Mulder. Well, if nothing happens here on this drive, the Royals will set up Gehlen with terrible field position and not a lot of time left. 8:20 to go in the game, and with the way Galen's had to move the football, that is a long time to get downfield. Second down and goal from the Gehlen Catholic 9. Out of the pistol is Peterson. Two receivers left, one right. He turns and gives to Mulder. Straight up the middle, he's got some green to the 5, and he's stood up at the 4-yard line, brought down for a gain of 5. It'll be third down and goal now to the Gehlen Catholic 4-yard line. 5 yards on the carry by Mulder. 7:50 to go in regulation. MMCRU is just a few yards away from making this a two-score ball game. It has been no further than 7 points. It was 7-0, 14-7, 21-14, and now it's 28-21. We have not had a two-score ball game yet tonight. Third and goal from the four, Jonah Peterson under center and I formation. It's John Schmill in a play-action bootleg rolling to his left, being chased by Aiden Ruhlin, throws, and that ball is deflected and incomplete. That was deflected by a couple of Jays there. Will Harpinaw was there. Now fourth and goal upcoming. And, oh, this is close now. You're on the right hash, so this is a chip shot. They are not going to bring Cody Evans out for a field goal, I don't believe. It's fourth and goal from the four. You got to find a way to get six here. Another huge fourth down here for MMCRU. Three receivers left, one right. Jonah Peterson's in the pistol, takes the snap. He's looking left, now looking right. He's got nowhere to throw. Runs to his left. He turns up the middle of the field and dives into the end zone. He's in. Touchdown, MMCRU. Jonah Peterson with his second touchdown run of the evening. It goes for 4 yards on fourth down, and MMCRU is up two scores. It's 34-21 Royals here with 7:10 to play in regulation. What a big play from a big-time player in Jonah Peterson. He scored twice on the ground, twice through the air. And now Cody Evans is in to try and tack on the point after.
Number 64, Cody.
Michael Schmellen is in there to hold for Evans as well. 34-21 MMCRU, 7:10 to play. Snap, spot is good. Evans, and his kick is blocked. Kick is blocked, no good, so it will remain 34-21 with 7:10 to play in the ballgame. We'll take a timeout. Galen's got their work cut out for them. Down 13 points with over 7 minutes to go. We're back after this on KLEM.
At American Bank, we believe in offering you what you want in a bank. Free checking, free debit and ATM cards, extended lobby and drive-up hours, competitive loans and deposit rates, online and mobile banking with bill payment and mobile deposit services. American Bank, achieving success together for over 130 years.
Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
It's the corner for fashion. Clausen's on the corner downtown Lamar's. For men's, young men's, and ladies' clothing, a shoe department, and formal wear, too. In-store alterations, gift cards, and personal service. Clausen's on the corner, downtown Lamar's.
Floyd Valley Healthcare wants you to play at the peak of your skills. Don't forget to stretch your muscles, hydrate, and schedule your wellness checks to reach your full potential. Best of luck from Floyd Valley Healthcare in Lamar.
This is Kale Pearson, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
We welcome you back here to Marcus Haroldwood Field, site of the district opener between Gehlen Catholic and MMCRU. And the Royals have taken things over here in the second half. 13 unanswered points as MMCRU up 34-21, trying to defeat Gehlen Catholic for the first time as an 11-man program consolidated with Marcus Merritt and Clegg Horn and Remsen Union. A Jonah Peterson touchdown run capped off an 8-play, 4-minute drive, 26 yards after the interception by Kyler Bork. Here's a squib kick. Gehlen fields it with an up back. Taken to the 35-yard line, and on the return is Brant Klein. Klein gets across the 40-yard line, and he is dropped at about the 42, roughly speaking anyway. So Brant Klein fielded the squibber pretty well and actually gives Gehlen some good field position here. They'll have it first and 10, or again, right in between the 42 and 43. We'll say 43. Let's go with the 43-yard line. 7:04 to play in regulation. Galen's got to score now. You don't really talk about must-score drives very often, but the Jays have to score, and they have to score with a little bit of haste. Three receivers right, one left. McCarty's in the gun. An knee-high snap as he runs to his left. He's going to keep as he gets some positive yardage across the 45, just down there at the 45. Pickup of two for Cole McCarty. It'll be second down and 8 here for Gehlen Catholic. Jays are down 34-21 here to MMCRU. The Royals have scored 13 unanswered points here in the second half. 6:35 to go in regulation, 34-21 MMCRU. It's Cole McCarty lining up in the pistol. Three receivers right, one left. And McCarty takes the snap, gives on the counter left side. Pearson carries up the middle. He gets 2 yards to the 48. Stop there of forward progress. A pickup of three to the 48. And it'll be now third down and five to go for Gehlen Catholic. And they just cannot run the football now. The Jays had 206 yards on the ground at half. Since then, just 31 yards on the ground. Third down and five for the Jays of their own 48. The Royal bench is beside themselves right now. McCarty rolling right. He's throwing, and that pass is in and out of the hands of a defender. Michael Peterson was right there but couldn't bring it in. It's an incomplete pass. Fourth down and five upcoming for the Jays. 5:44 to play in regulation. And this is where you have to go for him. You don't have an option. Gehlen Catholic needs to convert this fourth down try to keep their chances of winning the ball game going. Fourth and five from the Gehlen 48, maybe 47-yard line. Cole McCarty lines up in the gun, Pearson off the right hip. Three receivers right, one left. The snap to McCarty, rolls out to his right. He throws up the sideline, throws behind Chance Kalson. Incomplete, a turnover on downs, and it'll be MMCRU football. Well, the second half drives for Gehlen Catholic have been unproductive, to say the least. A fumble, a punt, an interception, and a turnover on downs. MMCRU going to get it at the Gehlen Catholic 48-yard line. Now with 5:40 to go in regulation, and of course they can try and go for the throat punch if they want to really take it to Gehlen Catholic, or they can just be very slow, methodical, churn some clock, run the football. But MMCRU starting to feel it. They've never beaten Gehlen Catholic as an 11-man program. And you have to go a long time since MMC was an 11-man program. First down and 10 of the Gehlen 48. Peterson gives left side. Brayson Mulder, he picks up a couple of yards to the 46. Be second down and a long eight to go as Brayson Mulder starts working his way towards 100 yards. He's got 17 carries, 79 yards. No rushing touchdowns yet for Brayson Mulder on the night. Now with 5:15 to go in regulation, and if MMCRU is going to do one thing, they're going to take that play clock all the way down here in quarter number four. 34-21, MMCRU leads Gehlen Catholic. Play clock's down to 10. Yeah, they're going to take that down to about 5 or 3 before they snap the football. With 5, Jonah Peterson calls the snap. Hands left side out of the I formation look. Peterson keeps moving his feet and picks up positive yardage to the 43. It is a gain of 3 for Brayson Mulder. Third down and 5 upcoming here for MMCRU from the Gehlen Catholic 43. Well, MMCRU had a really rough first week, losing to Cherokee 51-23. But now the Royals are just a few minutes away from starting off district play 1-0 and picking up their first win over Gehlen Catholic as an 11-man program. As a consolidation, MMCRU. Third down and a long five to go. Peterson, the knee-high snap, looking right, now looking left, has some time, trying to run. He's dragged down for a loss by Will Harpinoff. They got him down to the 47. It's going to be a loss of 5 yards for Jonah Peterson. Will set up fourth down and five. Clock stops, 4 minutes to go, and a timeout for Gehlen Catholic. So the Jays might have bought themselves a little bit of time, but will now have to get a good run back on a punt. 4 minutes to go in the game. It is 34-21 MMCRU. It's fourth down and 10 for the Royals when we come back here on KLEM Lamar's.
You You have big plans this fall, so use the equity in your home to free up some cash. Northwest Bank has three home equity loan options available. You get to choose from a fixed rate or variable rate loan. Get ready to remodel your home, buy a car, or take a vacation, whatever you want. These special loan rates are for a limited time. Apply online at nw.bank. Call 800-678-4105 for details. Northwest Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Commitment you can bank on.
This is Cole McCarty, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
We welcome you back here to Harold Wood Field in Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio, online audio at KLEM1410.com, and video streaming this contest on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel. 4 minutes to go in regulation. It's 34-21 MMCRU. The chips are stacked against the Jays right now, but they are going to get the football back. It's Owen Schrader out to boot it away here on 4th and 10. Of course, if you're on that other side of the field for Gehlen Catholic, you can't count yourself out of a ball game. Just got to keep working on it. This one's off the side of Schrader's foot, and this is going to bounce out of bounds at the 34-yard line of Gehlen Catholic. Nets only 14 yards on the punt. And so Gehlen Catholic will start 1st and 10 of their own 34. Wait a minute, there's a scrum happening after the play, and a flag is thrown. So there might be some more for Gehlen, less for Gehlen. Who knows? It depends who this is on. Kyle Oswald is not pleased with one of his players on the bench after he ripped him out of that little scuffle. Jeremy Schindler's not pleased as well. The last thing you want in this game is to turn into a brawl and more physical than a 13-point game needs to be with 4 minutes to go. A couple of area teams who know each other well have a ton of respect for each other as well. 3:55 to go in the game. Gehlen Catholic's going to get the football. Of course, all of that occurred after the punt, so there'd be no way that can alter who has the ball. It's just a question of could this just be offsetting penalties? Could it be all on one team? Let's see. Our white hat is going to call a personal foul on MMCRU. That'd be a 15-yard penalty. There's also unsportsmanlike conduct on Gehlen Catholic. So they will offset, and Gehlen Catholic's going to get the football back at the 34, I think, is where the spot is.
Offset.
So offsetting penalties. Where are they going to spot this ball? They will spot it. Looks like the 31. 31 is where they deem that punt to have gone out of bounds. Nope, they're actually going to move it up a little bit. Hang on. Yeah, I thought that went out at the 34. Again, it's only 3 yards one way or the other. 3:55 to go in regulation. Gehlen Catholic now gets the football. They've got it at their own 34-yard line. And now, for sure, it is must-score territory for Gehlen Catholic. 1st and 10 of the 34. McCarty's in the gun. He takes the bell, high snap, drops to throw. He lobs it up over the left seam and overthrows Landon Ryder. An incomplete. It's an incomplete pass. 2nd down and 10. Upcoming on the overthrown ball of Landon Ryder. So 2nd down and 10, 3:50 to go in this ball game. 34-21, MMCRU leading Gehlen Catholic. Jays have it at their own 34. And Gehlen Catholic heads to the line of scrimmage, trying to avoid going 0-2 to start the year, something they are not familiar with here the last few years. Two receivers either side, pistol look. McCarty rolls right, passes deflected up in the air, and a fight for the ball results in it falling incomplete. That ball got deflected. Looked like maybe Michael Peterson got a hand on that ball. It's an incomplete pass. Now 3rd down and 10 here for Gehlen Catholic from their own 34-yard line. 34-21, MMCRU leads Gehlen Catholic. The Royals have taken advantage of two turnovers, one turnover on downs, scored 13 unanswered here in this second half. McCarty in the pistol. A two-receiver look on either side. Gives the counter left side. Pearson turns up the seam to the 40. Gets a block to the sideline. 45-50. He's in the open field. 45. Jukes away from Kyler Borg. 40-35 and deep into Royal territory. He gets to the 34-yard line. No flags on the play. It's a gain of 32. And it's a first down for Gehlen Catholic to the MMCRU 34-yard line. A big carry. That's what the Jays needed with 3:36 to go here in regulation. 34-21, MMCRU leads Gehlen Catholic. Jays have they have two timeouts remaining, excuse me. Cole McCarty rolling out to his right. He's looking to throw. Now he looks to run. Turns up the seam to the 31, and that's where he is stopped. They'll give him the 31, gain of three. And it'll be second down at about 6 to go. They'll give him the 30 as well. I misspoke there. 4-yard gain for McCarty. Second down, excuse me. Second down at about 6 to go here for Gehlen Catholic. Now at 3 minutes to go in the game. Down 13. Two receivers either side. McCarty gives left side. It's Pearson for no gain. He gets stopped at the line of scrimmage. Michael Peterson there. Brace and Mulder on the stop as well. It'll be third down and 6 here for Gehlen Catholic. Third down and 6, 2:38 to go in the game. 34-21, MMCRU. The Royals just need one more defensive stand, and they should be able to walk out of here with a win. Third and 6, McCarty fakes the give. He's running to his right, being chased, hit by Mulder, throws out of bounds. Right sideline, a flag comes out. There's a flag out. This might be roughing the passer. We'll see. That would be a very, very rough, very tough roughing the passer call. Could be a late hit as well. We'll see. Boy, this is going to be really interesting. Kyle, I'm with Kyle Oswald right now. I don't think he's very pleased that flag is on the field. It's third and 6. There was an incomplete pass. It'd be fourth and 6 without the penalty. Let's see what we got. Personal foul, face mask. Okay, face mask is the call. So it's a 15-yard penalty and automatic first down. They were at the 30, so it's either half the distance or 15 yards anyway. Up to the MMCRU 15. So that was one I was not able to see either way. So first down and 10 of the 15. Three receivers left, one right, low snap. McCarty fakes the give. Carries left side, gets to the 10, down to the 5, close to the 5. He's down at about the 7. It's a pickup of 8 yards for Cole McCarty. Second down and 2. Now with 2:08 to play here in Marcus. 2 minutes to go. 34-21. MMCRU up on Gehlen Catholic. McCarty in the pistol. Three receivers right, one left. McCarty takes the snap, gives right side. Pearson turns up the middle. He's got a first down. He keeps lowering his shoulder, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Gehlen Catholic. Touchdown, Gehlen Catholic. It's a 7-yard carry for Cole McCarty. And the Jays have gotten within a score. The clock has stopped, minute 48 to go, as there is an injured Jay on the field. It is a touchdown, though, for Cale Pearson. It's his third rushing touchdown, and we'll await to see the status of that injured Jay on the field. Right now it's 34-27 MMCRU. With a minute 48 to go, the Jays have 2 timeouts remaining. They had to use one when they got the ball back here ahead of the punt. And now Gehlen Catholic walking that injured player off of the field. Is it Dane Lehman? Looks like Dane Lehman on that far sideline. Maybe Will Harpin. I can't tell if it's a 5 or a 6 there in front. But it'll be a point after try here for Dylan Pacus. 34-27, MMCRU. This is a big point after. If they get it, then a touchdown and a point after would give them the lead if they get even a chance to do that. Of course, they're going to need a huge defensive stop the other way. So here's the snap, the spot, and Dylan Pacus's point after try is no good. It's no good. He missed it wide left, and the score remains 34-27 MMCRU. Now with a minute 48 to go, we'll take a break, come back. More high school football after this on KLEM Radio.
Young and old alike enjoy the competition of high school sports. Some participate, some watch, and some remember how it was. It's only a game, but it offers great life lessons and memories that last a lifetime. A few thoughts from Dan and Lori Rexwinkle of Rexwinkle Funeral Homes in Lamar's in Akron.
Hey, Bobby Blazer, how long have you been waiting in that line? Head over with me to Easy Clean Car Wash. They're going to get you in and out in no time and make that black coat of yours look like $1 million.
Say, thanks there, Mickey Mustang. I've been out four-wheeling. I got lots of mud and stuff in my wheel wells and other places as well.
Bobby, didn't Libby Lexus tell you that Easy Clean Car Wash will pre-spray those hard-to-reach places, give you a quick massage, and make you feel and look like a whole new truck?
So that's what Libby Lexus has been up to. You know, Mickey, she's looking fine.
Easy Clean Car Wash on 12th Street, east of Hy-Vee and Lamar's.
Prime Bank is pleased to support educational opportunities at Gehlen Catholic and Lamar's community. We're proud to support our students in the classroom, on the playing field, in the band room, on stage, or in any extracurricular activity. Prime Bank works hard to help all of our children excel in their endeavors.
Member FDIC.
This is Landon Rader, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
We welcome you back here to Harrelwood Field in Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you here on KLEM Radio. Online audio at KLEM1410.com. Well, it is still very tough sledding up ahead here for Gehlen Catholic, but they've given themselves at least a chance. That's a small chance, but it is a chance nonetheless. A minute 48 to go, 34-27. MMCRU leads Gehlen Catholic, and the Royals better get their hands team out there. The Jays, I think, are going to line this one up to try an onside kick. Gehlen has two timeouts remaining, so time-wise, they could get the ball back with a three and out with about less than a minute to go. But, of course, the onside kick, probably their best chance to get the ball back quickly. Dylan Pacus lines it up. The Royals need a good recovery here. It's, of course, got to go 10 before the Jays can pick it up. Pacus' kick takes a roll across midfield. The Royals dive on it with Jonah Peterson. He's down to the MMCRU 49, and it'll be first and 10 for MMCRU. And now they just need one first down to win the ball game now. Minute 48 to go. MMCRU's got the ball. One first down will do the trick. It might not even need to be a first down, depending on how the plays go and how the timeouts are used. 34-27, MMCRU leads Gehlen Catholic, and just need a first down to take their first win over the Jays since joining forces as MMC and RU. First and 10 of the 49. I formation, Jonah Peterson under center. He takes the snap, gives right side. Brayson Mulder gets positive yardage, stood up at the Gehlen 46. It's a pickup of five, and Jeremy Schindler calls his second timeout of the half. A pickup of five here for Brayson Mulder, and a timeout on the field. We'll take one with the Jays. They have one remaining with a minute 39 to go. 34-27 MMCRU, second and five for the Royals, and we come back to Marcus here on KLEM Radio.
Make sure your life runs smoothly with an upgraded internet package from Premier Communications, connecting you with the internet speed and television access package that best fits your wants and needs. Premier Communications is happy to support our area coaches, athletes, and the parents who support them. Have a great season.
Williams & Company, certified public accountants, congratulates all area athletes in support of excellence, good sportsmanship, and the spirit of teamwork. A proud sports sponsor, Williams & Company, CPAs, your full-service business advisor, with a local office in Lamar's.
Being on the winning team in Northwest Iowa for over 130 years, Iowa State Bank is a proud supporter of all our area high school sports teams.
Iowa State Bank, we're ready for you.
This is Nolan Ellis, and you are listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
We welcome you back here to Harrelwood Field in Marcus. Second down and five upcoming for the Royals. Minute 39 to go, 34-27 MMCRU from the Gehlen Catholic 46. A Royal first down should seal the deal. Jonah Peterson under center, I formation. He takes the snap, looks for a screen pass right side. It's caught by Kyler Borg. Can he get a first down? He does, and more. 40, 35, 30, and he's run out of bounds inside the 35 to the 32. It's a screen pass of 14 yards, and what a play call by Coach Oswald. I think everybody in this facility was going to say, all right, they're going to try and run it up the middle. But they go to the screen pass outside. First and 10 for MMCRU with a minute 33 to go. And this should be all she wrote. Gehlen has only one timeout left. Down by 7 late. First and 10 here at the Gehlen 34. A handoff up the middle. It is Mason Mulder in that pile, carrying for 4 yards to the 30. And a timeout is called by Jeremy Schindler, the head coach of Gehlen Catholic, on the 4-yard carry, by Brayson Mulder. Got a timeout on the field. The last timeout of the night for Gehlen Catholic. Minute 26 to go, 34-27 MMCRU. Back after this here on KLEM.
Hi, this is Julie Hurt with Century 21 ProLink in Lamar's, your local real estate expert dedicated to results. Whether buying or selling a home, call me, Julie Hurt, with Century 21 ProLink in Lamar's at 540-7757. That's 540-7757.
LSI Staffing has one mission: to match employers with great employees. If your manufacturing business is looking to partner with an industry leader, LSI Staffing is worth the call. Call them today at 712-202-2850.
This is Will Harpenaugh, and you're listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
We welcome you back to Harold Woodfield and Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you. Gehlen Catholic has used their final timeout with a minute 26 to go in regulation. 34-27 MMCRU advantage. And the Royals have second down and about 6 to go from the Gehlen 30-yard line, trying to seal their first win over the Jays since joining forces MMC and RU. Peterson under center, gives to Brayson Mulder. He's stood up by Will Harpenaugh for a gain of a yard to the 29.
No gain on the play.
Maybe just a yard pickup for Brayson Mulder. It'll be third down and a long 5 to go. And now the clock just keeps ticking down. Tick, tick, tick. Can't go any faster on that MMCRU side of the field. Minute 2 to go. Even if the Jays make a stop here, I don't know that MMCRU is going to be forced to either go for it or punt it. They might not have to take a snap on fourth down. I think Coach Oswald's going to take this play clock all the way down and call a timeout. 46-45, play clock's at 5 as well. Oswald takes it down to 2, down to 1, and he calls a timeout with 39.5 seconds left to go in regulation. The score, 34-27, MMCRU Royals with their first of 3 timeouts are back for the third down play after this on KLEM.
A home is a safe place to be, a roof over your head, and 4 walls to keep out the heat and cold. It's a child's laughter, a mother's song, and a father's strength. It's where we go for comfort and to share joy. It's your first school and your first church. It's where memories are shared. Hi, this is Julie Hurt, your Century 21 ProLink real estate agent. Whatever a home means to you, I am here to help you find the home you are looking for. Call 540-7757 and let me, Julie Hurt, help you make a house your new home.
This is Gabe Wilchin, and you are listening to Jays Football on KLEM.
We welcome you back here to Harold Woodfield and Marcus. Daniel Versteg with you on KLEM Radio. It is third down and long 5 at about the 29-yard line of Gehlen Catholic. 39.5 seconds to go in the game. And if the Royals just play their cards right here, run the football, there is no need for them to snap the ball on fourth down. The game clock is under 40 seconds. Of course, the play clock gets reset to 40. It is third down and a long 5. They will line up in the victory formation. Jonah Peterson takes the knee, and now the celebrating can get started on the MMCRU side of the field. For the first time as a consolidated 11-man program, Marcus Merritt and Cleghorn Remsen Union has taken down Gehlen Catholic, and they will start district playoff with a 1-0 record. Your final score from Marcus here tonight, it's MMCRU 34, Gehlen Catholic 27. What a showing by the Royals, especially after a tough loss last week at the hands of Cherokee. Once again, your final score, MMCRU 34, Gehlen Catholic 27. The Royals improved to 1-1 on the year, now 1-0 in district play in Class A District 1. Gehlen Catholic drops to 0-2, now 0-1 in district play. Take a break, come back, have some post-game thoughts for you, and wrap it up when we come back to Harold Woodfield and Marcus. You're listening to high school football here on KLEM Radio.
Gehlen Catholic School, excellence in education, leadership through Christ. For information, check their website at GehlenCatholic.org.
Success is born of skill and team. Like the teams playing, CNOS has combined award-winning skill and teamwork into the premier medical facility in the region. For the areas of joint, bone, muscle, nerve, and brain are treated with the skills of comprehensive care from a team of highly trained experts. And CNOS takes care of many of the student-athletes in Siouxland. CNOS is proud to bring you this game. Go to CNOS.net to learn more.
Colbeck Incorporated is proud to support local high school athletics. They encourage you to play hard and play smart and always show good sportsmanship. Best of luck from your friends, Brian, Kevin, and Wayne Colbeck.
Peace Pizza House is your destination before and after the game. Whether you need to feed the whole family or just looking to get out before the game, make sure to stop at Peace Pizza House. You'll find many appetizers, burgers, salads, pasta, and of course, Peace Pizza House outstanding pizza selections. Your entire family is sure to find something they're looking for. Peace Pizza House would like to wish our local teams the best of luck this season.
Murphy Collins and McGill PLC in Lamar's supports our local student-athletes, trusted for generations with reliable legal guidance. So when you are in need of legal services, consult with one of the attorneys at Murphy Collins and McGill PLC, located at 38 First Avenue, Northwest Lamar's, Iowa. Kemp's Dairy of Lamar's is a proud supporter of area athletics. They focus on strong, healthy bodies with all their dairy products. And they continue to strive hard to provide the best possible dairy products to their customers. That's Kemp's Dairy of Lamar's.
Get a special loan rate from Northwest Bank. Remodel your home, take a vacation, or buy a car. Use the equity in your home for what you want. Northwest Bank's home equity line of credit special of 6.99% annual percentage rate, fixed for 6 months, then variable rate thereafter, currently 7.50% APR. Offer available for a limited time to qualified borrowers. Call 800-678-4105 for details about credit cost and terms. Apply online at nw.bank.
Commitment you can bank on.
Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Lamar's Community Athletic Boosters are proud supporters of this broadcast. Hard work and determination are vital to the success of our area athletics. The Lamar's Community Athletic Boosters are proud to stand behind our athletes and coaches as they work toward success on the field and in the classroom.
When it comes to service, your Lamar's Hy-Vee is number one for shopping both in-store and online. Save with the Fuel Saver Plus Perks Rewards Program at Hy-Vee, where there's a helpful smile in every aisle.
Have a great season. Huddle up and win from Noram Cold Storage, the coolest cold storage in the Midwest. Over 20 years of experience in packing, cooling, storing, and managing your products with exceptional service. Noram Cold Storage in Lamar's.
This is Jeremy Schindler, head coach for the Gehlen Catholic football team. You're listening to Jays Football on 1410 AM, 96.9 FM, KLEM.
And we welcome you back to our post-game coverage here tonight from Harold Wood Field and Marcus. MMCRU football gets to ring the bell after a 34-27 victory over Gehlen Catholic. The first time they've been able to do that as a consolidated 11-man program. And the Royals start off district play with a 1-0 record, tied for first place in the district, 1-1 overall after a 34-27 victory over Gehlen Catholic here tonight. The Jays start things off 0-2. They are 0-1 in district play to start the year. Let's take a look at some of the numbers here from tonight's ball game. First for MMCRU, recording 298 unofficial yards of total offense, 128 on the ground, 170 passing. Jonah Peterson completes 13 out of his 17 attempts for those 170 yards. He threw for two touchdowns. He also ran for another two with eight carries, 17 positive yards for two scores. Dawson Picks, six carries, 19 yards and a touchdown. Kyler Bork, he had seven receptions, 75 yards, and a receiving touchdown. Gage Johnson, one catch, 28 yards, and a touchdown. Jace Culling had five catches, 74 yards. He did not get into the end zone here tonight. Gehlen Catholic, 288 yards of total offense, all of them coming on the ground. Cale Pearson with 27 carries for 219 yards, three touchdowns. Cole McCarty, 12 carries, 69 yards, and a rushing touchdown here tonight as MMCRU comes away with a big 34-27 victory over Gehlen Catholic to start district playoff with a 1-0 record. So happy for MMCRU. They've been through a lot since making the leap to 11-man, of course, joining forces as a school district. And, man, that is great to see. Really excited for Coach Oswald. He was so disappointed with how the game against Cherokee ended last week. And I know his guys were, too, and now they get to celebrate with the home fans and do some royal jumping jacks after a victory over Gehlen Catholic here tonight. Final score, 34-27. MMCRU starts off district play 1-0, 1-1 overall now. Gehlen Catholic 0-2 and 0-1 in the district. We don't have a whole lot of final scores to run down for you here tonight, but make sure you check out KLEM1410.com later on this evening. Our sports scores and results page will have you covered with all the scores from around Plymouth County and Northwest Iowa. You can check that out at KLEM1410.com. Make sure you tune in to tomorrow morning's edition of the KLEM Coach's Corner. We'll have Ken Vigdahl on. The Bulldogs won tonight 38-14. We'll have Jeremy Schindler on to recap this contest for Gehlen Catholic. Then we're also going to have Akron Westfield head coach John Sievert on. The Westerners were up at the break, and hopefully that held true. Of course, you'll be able to find out pretty quickly on the coach's corner if that did not hold true. It looks like it will. The last update had it 45-18 in quarter number four. So good news all around for some of our Plymouth County schools here tonight. Again, the final, MMCRU 34, Gehlen Catholic 27. Thanks for tuning into this edition of Gehlen Catholic and MMCRU football. Thanks to our video sponsors, Pease Pizza House, Easy Clean Car Wash, Julie Hurt, Realtor with Century 21 ProLink, and Northwest Bank for bringing you the action here tonight. Our thanks to Luke Larson for running our video stream as well this evening on the KLEM Radio YouTube channel. And thanks once again to you all for tuning in to this edition of High School Football. For all of us at KLEM Radio, for KLEM Sports, Daniel Versteg with you. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll talk to you tomorrow morning on the KLEM Coach's Corner. We'll talk to you next week with some high school volleyball, and we'll be in Hull next week for football as Lamar's takes on Boyden Hall Rock Valley. Until then, so long.
This is 1410 KLEM Lamar's and on 96.9 FM.
I'm here without you, baby, but you're still alive.